45 seconds, Matt Sundin. And the Toronto Maple Leafs at Buffalo. Actually, the puck won't drop for about 38 minutes. Sabres lead 2-1. Tomorrow afternoon, Colorado-Dallas. The Western Final is tied at 2. And a reminder, our next telecast, a week from today at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific, Interleague play, the Montreal Expos and the Blue Jays from here at Skydome. Again, the final score, the New York Yankees defeat Toronto 8-3. New York moving back to within a half game of the first place Boston Red Sox, who this afternoon defeated the Cleveland Indians. Jason Grimsley strong in relief of David Cone. Now for John Cerruti, I'm Brian Williams. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. So long from Skydome. Now, Hockey Night in Canada.
The following is a live presentation of CBC Sports. To Labatt Saturday Night. From Buffalo, here is your host, Ron McClain.
Thanks, Bob Bolving. Thanks to all the training staffs of the Buffalo Sabres and the Toronto Maple Leafs. Thanks to the fans who've gathered at Marine Midland Arena for Game 4 of the Eastern Conference Final. It was busy on the Peace Bridge coming in. It's jammed here in the press box and in the stands. There's the Dominator. He and Domi were at it at the end of the game. It was Dwayne Roloson finishing up for Dominik Hasek, who returned successfully. Matt Sundin and the Maple Leafs felt they played well in Game 3 in the first period. Then 2 goals 38 seconds apart, 3 goals in 4.5 minutes, and Buffalo, with those 3 unanswered goals, cruising to a victory. So they have the 2-1 series lead. Now Toronto knows it's crucial. Even though they're going home, they've got to get it rolling. Game 4 last night in the series between Dallas and Colorado, a wild finish in overtime. Chris Cuthbert was on hand to describe Chris Drury's game winner.
Rush at the end. It's Drury over the line, and he couldn't set up Forsberg. Oserlund steps up. He's got Drury in front. Shot! Scores! Chris Drury!
Eddie Belfort made 41 straight saves, but the Colorado Avalanche even the series at 2, bound for Game 5 tomorrow afternoon at Reunion in Texas. Other news today we'll get to in just a couple of minutes. Scotty Bowman has joined us live here ringside, and Scott Oak is down at the benches for a thought on tonight's Game 4 between Toronto and Buffalo.
Ron, certainly no debate is required to figure out which is the more desperate team tonight. Should the Leafs lose, the Ovechkins will be on standby. Pat Quinn's been hard on his first two lines in his press briefings in the past few days, saying the Pretty Boys could not get it done in Game 3. His challenge to his team tonight, reestablish the intensity that helped get them to the first two rounds of the Stanley Cup tournament. And to that end, Quinn will probably have at least one lineup change tonight. The Sabres certainly look as though they're in the driver's seat. Not to be overlooked is the coaching job Lindy Ruff has done here in Buffalo. And on the headliner, we'll talk to Ruff about his battle for respect in Buffalo. Ron?
Thank you, Scott. Adam Mayer goes in for Derek King for Toronto. The big news in Montreal is that Trevor Linden is the newest tab. He signed a 4-year, $15 million contract today. So Linden goes to Montreal, back to Canada, back to a hockey hotbed. We asked him about the pressure he'll face there.
Well, I think I really value playing in Canada. I think there's something special about that. I enjoyed my time here in Vancouver, and I think I missed that. And I talked with Jeff Hackett today just about that, and he said, yeah, it's a pressure-filled, and there's expectations, but it's a great atmosphere to play in and to focus in, so I'm looking forward to it.
Well, Scotty Bowman, of course, is a hero in Montreal. 1,100 career victories, 200 in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and those 8 trophies. Scotty, what did you think of Linden going to Montreal?
Well, it's a reverse of the trends because it said that the Islanders was a bit of a money deal. Montreal has to retool a little bit. I think it was a good move for them. He's an established player. He'll bring credibility to their team, and they need help right away.
Would you make him a front-line player and ask him to score for you, or just for the leadership, maybe like a Carvin?
Well, I think he can play two ways. I think Trevor can score more goals than he did this year. I think in Montreal, the atmosphere will help him. And they had some players last year that had an off season, and I think they can get them back.
By the way, congratulations on your decision to return. That's great news for us watching, and I know for Detroit fans. I should ask you about Buffalo-Toronto. There's a lot at stake here for the Maple Leafs. What do you think is the key tonight?
Well, obviously, I've always said right from the start, if Hasek can get hot, the other night he was good enough to win. But I think Curtis Joseph can win a game for Toronto. That's what they have to have because Curtis, the first game, he didn't have as much work as he wanted. He was good in the second game. I don't think you can fault him in game three. But Buffalo, they came out storming. I think what you'll see tonight, though, the Leafs, if they can get by the first 10 minutes, this is a big game because it evens the series up. We see last night the overtime. One goal means two games. It's an awful big game.
You think Toronto was satisfied that they held Buffalo in the game the other night? They got through the first period with a lead, didn't give up that first goal. Maybe they sat back after 20 minutes?
Well, except with about 5 minutes to go, they're still only down a goal. I thought Buffalo played them for most of the game, but Toronto's got to get something on the power play. There'll be some more penalties tonight. We know now there are always a few, and Buffalo's power play has been a surprise of the playoffs for all the teams.
How come? Why are they so good on the power play?
Problem for the reason that they're not counting on the same guys that are doing everything else. And I noticed a lot of times Pekka isn't on the power play. They had Primo in front. Of course, he won't play tonight. Holzinger. Lindy and Mike Ramsey and Donnie Lever have taken players that you wouldn't expect to do well on the power play. I think it's taken pressure off other players. So it's a well-balanced team.
Wayne Primo's out, as you say, with a knee injury, so Rob Ray is going in for Lindy Ruff in this game. How about the shenanigans at the end? I'm exactly, just with your raised eyebrow, tell me what you think of that. Quinn said, no comment. Lindy looked really emotional at the end of a big win.
Well, I think everybody's always worried about their goaltender, and especially one that's injured, and they even took the extra precaution to get him out of there with a few seconds left. But the main thing you don't want to have happen near the end of the game, Ron, is something foolish to happen where you get a suspension. So I think when it's over, both teams say nothing really happened and nobody got suspended and nobody got hurt.
How about Colorado-Dallas? What a game last night. Where do you see that one, Eddie?
Boy, playing again tomorrow at 1 o'clock Dallas time. Those teams, I think the health of the team is going to be crucial. If they lose Kaminsky and Hajduk for tomorrow's game, that's a big loss. I don't know about the injuries to Dallas with Carbonell and Matvichuk, but with the age of Dallas, it's a huge game for Dallas because I don't think they'd want to go into Colorado down 3-2.
Right. We heard that Matvichuk will play. Scott Russell, Kelly Rudy are filing a report. Kaminsky's supposed to play. Hajduk's gone, collarbone. So that, as you always have said, attrition is such a huge thing. If you can have players coming back into the lineup like Buffalo has, right?
Yeah, and you know, Ryan, when you look at the four goaltenders that are here now, that the game last night, I think anything less than what we would have had, we could have had a 5-4 game. Both goalies gave their teams more than one chance to win.
Well, and we'll see the same here tonight. You know it's going to be a heck of a duel between
hockey. That's what hockey's all about.
Got it. Sorry, yours was injured when you started that third rounder. It might have been 3 straight Stanley Cups for William Scott Bowman. Thanks, Scotty, for joining us. There's Michael Pekka, heart and soul of the Buffalo Sabres. Toronto's really tried to defend him. And there's the 20-year-old who scored in his first Stanley Cup playoff game. He'll suit it up for Pat Quinn tonight.
Brought to you by Labatt Blue. A whole lot can happen out of the blue. And by The Home Depot, Canada's home improvement coach. Connected to the hottest hockey site on the web, CBC.ca is your passport to the playoffs. Up-to-the-minute scores and stats. Check out the video features. It's interactive and entertaining. Hockey online at CBC.ca. Get in on the game.
You come into the Home Depot, you get the same low price every single day. My job is making sure stock's put away, making sure price tags are up, and making sure customers are served.
So you bring
whether you're a contractor, or whether you're the guy down the street that's just coming in for a light bulb, you're guaranteed the low price in town. If you find the same item elsewhere at a lower price, we will match that price and give you an additional 10% off. This low price guarantee is effective throughout the store. Our goal at the Home Depot is to have the best price in town, bar none.
Miro Shatan returns with a big goal, the Buffalo Sabres 40-goal man this season. Obviously a huge presence along with the Dominator in Game 3. And there's Dmitry Yuskevich. I know Harry Neal feels he's got to be throwing the body around in the fourth game here tonight at Marine Midland Arena. Pat Quinn, head coach of the Toronto Maple Leafs, said he's got to find a way to will his team to think they can win. Here he is with Scott Oak.
Pat, it's already been a long playoff run. Are you at all concerned about that dreaded word complacency seeping in?
Oh, hardly at this point. Not with the thought of being in the final round for the big prize. I don't think that's a danger of worrying about at all with our club.
Pat, a lot was made over the pretty boys comment you made a couple of days ago. If the team obviously can't win by playing pretty hockey tonight, what kind of style must it play?
Well, there's only another way. When the puck's on the boards or in the pits, as we call it, you got to go there and play it there. There's no two ways about it. Before you can have the movement in your game, you got to get the puck. And the only place you can go get it sometimes is on the boards and in the pits.
What about the atmosphere in this building? Did that work in favor of the Sabres in Game 3?
Oh, I don't think so. I think their crowd is great. They've been up and they've been having a lot of fun here, and of course a lot more fun when their team wins. So, and you know, we've got enough Toronto people here, just enough cause enough of a stir. So it's been a pretty great place to play.
Pat, thanks for your time. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Ron, there's Pat Quinn, head coach of the Leafs.
Thank you, Scott and Pat. And there's the native of East Amherst, New York, and Topsail, Newfoundland, Bob Cole, Harry Neal. Gentlemen, how do you see it tonight, Bob?
I don't know. I'm just wondering, Harry. Rob Ray is playing tonight because of the Primo injury. Does that mean it's going to get even rougher?
Well, Buffalo has really pounded the Leafs, especially the Buffalo forwards, and Ray's going to add another dimension. If the Leafs bother Hasek as much as Hasek looked like he was bothered, I think we'll see a little bit more of Ray, because that's disturbing to Buffalo and Lindy Ruff, when the best goaltender he has and the one he just got back may get hurt again.
Ron, Scotty was talking about the two goalies. You know, I paid particular attention for a few minutes in watching Hasek warm up just a second ago. He's going up and he's going down and he's moving side to side. It's 48 hours since he played his first game after that groin injury, and he looks pretty sharp. Now, that may not be good news for Toronto fans, but at the other end, they've got a hot goalie too.
Curtis Joseph has to play his best game of the playoffs, not only this series, but the playoffs. If he does, we're going to see a great game, and the outcome is in doubt.
Leafs can't afford to go down 3-1, Ron.
No, absolutely not. You can't come back, but in the third round, it's tough to do it, although they've got a game at Air Canada Centre. You're right. This is everything for the Toronto Maple Leafs. They know they've got to get a good jump on Buffalo. The Sabres have scored first in 10 of 13 games. Well, the Florida connection's been a huge part, kind of like the French connection years ago. Here's Rhett Warner now with Scott Oak.
Ron, here's Rhett Warner. Rhett, you lead the series 2-1. You'll play tonight in front of a crowd that should be just as loud as it was for Game 3. How would you describe the Sabres situation?
Well, we like it. You know, we're playing pretty good at home, and, you know, we got the lead right now. But tonight's going to be a tough one. They're going to come out gunning, and we got to be ready.
When you got traded away from the team that was on its way to missing the playoffs, did you think you were coming to one that could go this far?
Well, it reminded me a lot of the team in Florida the year we went to the finals. We got a good goaltender and a defensive-minded team. We kind of scored by committee. So I was hopeful, and things are working out real good.
Thanks, Rhett. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you, Scott. That's a chap, of course, that Lindy Ruff knew well from his Florida days. There's Michael Groshek, who follows Dominik Hasek out for the warm-up. So they have a real connection. And there's Chris King. He's got his eyes on those Buffalo Sabres as we speak.
The Headliner, brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevrolet, tried, tested, and true. How far would we go to build just the right car for you? How about cup holders designed just for your kids? Standard air conditioning and automatic transmission. Is that too far? How about a car that will travel 160,000 kilometers before its first scheduled tune-up? How far will we go to exceed even your expectations of what a well-equipped quality car should be? As far as it takes.
Malibu.
Back at the Marina, Scott, how about tonight's headliner?
Ron, Lindy Ruff had a solid 10-year playing career with the Sabres, captained the team for 3 years, and seemed a logical choice to take over as head coach. But how could he have known how hard it would be to get respect?
Brownie and Joey, we're going to work off this suck. Joey on his foot pan here. Brownie, you're down low.
Look out!
If you get it, sometimes you maybe slip in the front of the net and take the play and go behind the net.
No, I'm not disappointing him at all. Not disappointing one bit. Just, he can't play with that pain. The pain has been too bad. He's been limping around. He would hurt the team. I think it's affected me more than it's affected him. Because it's my team people are going after. My players. And that hurts me.
Is this truly your team at last?
Well, I believe so. Obviously, we've got a great young team. We've got some good veteran players. I think there's some things in the past that people just haven't let go of, and I think some of my players have been criticized for it, but we've had a darn good 2 years, you know, since I've been here, and we've slowly been building an even better team, and I like our team, and I just took offense to it.
New owners take over, and the first thing they say is, there'll always be a place in this organization for Ted Nolan. How did that make you feel?
Well, I think my response to that was, if they've got their point, if you want to bring Ted back, do it now. I mean, fire me and do it now. I'd worked extremely hard at the job, and that was honestly how I felt. I think there was some loyalty towards Ted, and I didn't have a problem with that. But I was going to go about business my way. I told you we'd come to a certain date where I said, we're going to do it this way. If I'm going to go down, I might as well go down doing it the way I think is right.
Here's Mongrain working his way into the Islander zone. Mongrain, Sanders won, a shot, they score! Lindy Ruff at the edge of the crease.
You're a former captain of the team, but when you took over here as coach, they didn't like you, and they didn't want you here. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I think there was, you know, there was mixed emotions. I think my playing time here bought me some time. And I think if it was somebody totally new that would have went through what I went through in the first 3 months, they might have ran him right out of town. But I think there was some sentiment towards, the way he played and how hard he worked and what he gave to the team. Let's give him a chance.
Oh, there it is. As he skated by, Smith stuck his stick out and Ruff goes after him.
So this season, the Sabres are in a bit of a tailspin. You convene a meeting at Center Ice and impart a very powerful message on your team. What was that?
I mentioned my brother. Stu Barnes was a player that played against my brother in Bantam and Midget, and they were like 1-2 in the scoring all the time. And
I played a lot of hockey against him, and he was a super hockey player, super person. And
kind of gathered us all around and brought us up, brought up the years back. His brother was involved in a bus crash out west.
The question I asked Stu, I just said, where's my brother now? You know, and it was like the rink just got deathly silent.
Four junior hockey players were remembered today in Swift Current, Saskatchewan.
It makes you stop, and when things are going haywire, appreciate what you have and make sure that family does come first, because in the big picture, you don't have a lot of guarantees.
I think it was probably hard for him to do, but I think the message was loud and clear and very effective.
Singer, when it goes back to the middle guy, our middle guy's got to go. Like, we both kind of stood there. Middle guy go, the other guy just come back underneath again.
Good job, big guy, go, kind of boy.
Just gotta make sure when you're cutting through, even on the bounce, you gotta get it deep, you know? If you can't handle it, just wail at it, and if not, you gotta hit. Yeah, if you miss it, then you gotta stop and come right back. Don't go for the loop. Stop and come right back through the middle. Good job, way to skate.
If I was to tell you that people saw you as a marginal player who liked to have a lot of fun, but was never really a student of the game, would that surprise you?
No, it wouldn't surprise me. I was a player that enjoyed playing, and I had a lot of fun outside the game, and I was a practical joker most of the time.
He was kind of the joker in Florida under Roger Nelson and Doug McClain. He was assistant coach and a real joker, always always goofing around with the guys and always pulling pranks.
Well, there's been lots. I mean, I sewed Ron Greshner's wallet into his back pocket, and he stopped for gas and went to pay, and had to take his pants off to get the money out.
There's a defenseman who knows how to address him. What's he got left in his contract, Scott?
Ronnie's got a year left, and just look at the job Lindy Ruff has done here. He brought order out of chaos to start last season. He stared down the threat to have Ted Nolan return, and then he got the Sabres to the Final Four. So that was a masterful coaching job. Here are the Sabres again in the conference final. What else does Lindy Ruff have to do? If he did not re-sign here, you know there's a job waiting somewhere on the NHL for Ruff, and it's worth noting he's got a great relationship with Doug McLean, whom he assisted in Florida when McLean was head coach there. And McLean now, of course, is running the show with the expansion Columbus Blue Jackets. It's worth thinking about.
Well, you know, Darcy Regier got 4 years. They said that was crazy. He got three. They said that was crazy. And Dominic Hasek at $7 million sounded high. But best player in the NHL by next year, that will look like pocket change. Right, Ron Greschner? We'll continue. It's the Maple Leafs and the Sabres from Marine Midland Arena. Game four in the Eastern Final coming up.
The Headliner. Brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevrolet, tried, tested, and true.
Stick and pucks, $53. Wool caps, $42. NHL jersey, $114. 0 degrees, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Official card of the NHL and fan of the great frozen game.
Whoa, what's up?
What?
Call 911.
Oh, that looks bad.
It looks like he's trying to say Mike.
Mike. Mike.
Now, we've been hired by the victim's family. Can anyone tell us what happened?
Judging by the marks here and here, I'd say he'd been squeezed. Just a lemon. He never hurt anyone.
Don't worry, folks. We'll find this guy.
Welcome to the most glorious moment in Mary Webb's life. Seems Mary had always dreamed of participating in the Ironman. So Mary gave us a call. We made the money work, and Mary, she did the rest. And if you look real close, you can see just how happy she is. Go get 'em, Mary. Introducing a new way of borrowing, the Scotia Total Equity Plan. Get what you want out of life.
I've been seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through.
Have you seen Transitions lenses lately? Indoors, the changing tint is clearer. Outdoors, they're the darkest Transitions lenses ever. For all-day comfort and convenience, Transitions lenses, right in any light.
I'll be seeing you.
Visit our website or call 1-877-4-TRANSITIONS.
Welcome back to Labatt Saturday Night as we continue to set the scene for the Sabres and the Maple Leafs. Last night, the Western Conference Final Game 4 at McNichols Arena. Sandis Ozilinch intercepts to start the Wild finish in overtime as the Avs beat the Stars. Chris Drury is the hero, his goal coming with 30.8 seconds to go in the first overtime, and the series is now tied 2-2. Chris joins us now. Congratulations, Chris. When Ozilinch was feeding you the pass, what were you thinking?
Well, I was just trying to get it off quick. I didn't really know how much time was left in the period. I knew one of their defensemen, I think it might have been Sidor, was coming out. I thought he might go down and try to block it, so I was just trying to get it on net as high and as hard as I could.
Well, you sure did that. Eddie Belfour has been awfully tough to beat, allowing just 7 goals now in 4 games, including an overtime. You shot high. Has the team been instructed to try and go high on Belfour?
Yeah, it's something we talked about. Also, we just wanted to get a lot more traffic in front of him, and I think you saw that in our first 2 goals. Fleury screening him on the first one, and then Stefaniel on the second one. Shooting high and also just traffic, those are our 2 main goals.
Chris, it was such an intense game. The crowd was going wild at the finish. You knew you'd even the series heading to Dallas. What was the mood in the dressing room after the thrill of that win?
Oh, it was real exciting. Obviously, everyone was pretty fired up. It was a huge game for our team. We lose, we're down 3-1 heading back to Dallas. So everyone knew the importance of that game, and everyone was pretty happy we got it.
Valeri Kamensky skated, so you'll get him back, but now Milena Hayduk goes out with the shoulder separation or collarbone break, so you lose him. And with the length of the game, with the heat and the humidity in Dallas, do you think that fatigue will be a factor in Game 5?
I don't think so. Maybe if it was regular season, but this is the conference finals. I think everyone's going to be pretty fired up. damaged emotions will probably run over fatigue. So we're looking to have a good game Sunday, and that's a big game for both teams. We both want it bad, and it should be real exciting.
Well, Chris, you're cool about it. That was a great win. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
Chris Drury and the Colorado Avalanche at Dallas tomorrow at 2 o'clock Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific. Boy, we've got great fans at Marine Midland Arena for Game 4 here tonight. I wish I could show you the one behind the camera that I'm working in front of, but we just can't do that. She's not in sight. There you get a glimpse of some of the 18,585 fans on hand. By the way, out in Edmonton, you need 500 tickets sold to reach 13,000. So get down to SkyReach and buy your tickets, Oilers fans.
Future Look, the playoff edition. Brought to you by Ford. For now, forever.
The 96 playoffs, the kid was hot. Ed Jovanovsky next.
A powerful story.
They are making millions of dollars.
That changed the game of hockey forever.
I put together the finest team.
The NHL.
Yeah, yeah.
The Gemini Award-winning Network. Sunday on CBC. From the business in the boardrooms to the plays behind the plays.
He gets $800,000 for scoring 20 goals, and you should get the same.
A fascinating six-part series on a year in the life of the NHL. The New Ice Age, Monday, June 7th on CBC.
First thing you have to know, that's Lindy Ruff giving an earful to Ed Jovanovsky. So he taught Eddie well in 1996. Jovanovsky's 22 years old and was born in Windsor, Ontario. He played his junior career with the Spitfires and was drafted in 1994 by the Florida Panthers. In the 96 Stanley Cup playoffs, he had an amazing run. We all know what he did against Derek Lindros and the Flyers, but he was equally proficient against Pittsburgh and Colorado. 52 penalty minutes, 9 points to lead all Panther defensemen in 22 Stanley Cup playoff games.
Future Look, the playoff edition. Brought to you by Ford. For now, forever.
I'm not late. I'm right on time. It happened so fast. I knew I'd get here because I had help. And I'm ready to start something new. It's the last day of school.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
When the rain hits the road hits back. That's why you need the Rain Warriors from Bridgestone. Tires with a unique tread that cuts through water and pumps it away to beat the road. The Rain Warriors from Bridgestone. F1 thinking to outsmart the road.
I was a professional landscaper for 15 years prior to working at the Home Depot. I know what I'm talking about. What it does is it builds residual torque. It's got an 18-inch cut. The equipment that we have available for you here at the Home Depot is just going to knock your socks off. Scott's, Poulin, Longboy, Ryobi, Murray, Black & Decker, Echo Power Equipment, Charo, anything that's got a motor on it gives me goosebumps. With the right equipment, yard work is not a chore. It's our goal to have the best prices in all lawn and garden equipment.
These are the Schmitz of Munich. This is their new Porsche Boxster. In order to drive it Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Mr. Schmidt has agreed to assume dog washing responsibilities. And Mrs. Schmidt, in return for Tuesday, Thursday, and the coveted Saturday, has to make Mr. Schmidt's favorite Pinkelwurst 3 times a week. On Sundays, they share the Boxster. Of course, this leaves out young Dieter, who has just earned his driver's license. As in all domestic disputes, it's the children who suffer most. The Boxster. Once again, there is no substitute.
Brought to you by Labatt Blue. A whole lot can happen out of the blue. And by The Home Depot, Canada's home improvement coach.
About a minute to the start of Hockey Night in Canada. Our Labatt Saturday Night notes. Trevor Linden signs that draft pick will be 10th in the 99 entry draft. Hayduke out with a broken collarbone. And there's the latest on the Oilers season ticket drive. They need to get to $13,000 to get the $2.5 million from the NHL. Tomorrow, 8 to 8 at Sky Reach in Edmonton. You can go down. They've marked out all the seats that are still available, and you can buy your tickets right there and support the Oilers. You know, this marina is a beautiful rink, but they made one small mistake. They didn't provide for the organ player. How do I know that? Well, we'll just pan right across. You can see over to my right, camera left. There's Tim Wells of Buffalo, New York, who is providing the tunes here for the fans on hand at Marine Midland. It's game four coming up, the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Buffalo Sabres. Plenty to consider. Toronto down 2-1 in the series. When we come back, we'll join the 18,000 fans on hand to celebrate the Memorial Day long weekend in the United States with a dandy Saturday night clash between the Sabres and the Leafs.
Rise and fall of the movie moguls. Hollywoodism, June 6th.
You are watching CBC.
In Game 3, Toronto knew it would have to face Dominik Hasek, and the theory was simple. Get under his skin to keep him out of your head. Under his skin, keep him out of our head. The anatomy of a game plan, round one to the Dominator.
Just outside of Winnipeg, Marcus is on the phone talking to his boss, you know, breaking the news to him.
It's me, Marcus. Mr. Peters, listen, I'm gonna need a couple more weeks. Thank you.
So, how'd it go?
Oh, it's a Stanley Cup. He understands.
A whole lot can happen out of the blue. The bat blue.
He fired you, didn't he?
Yeah.
The 99 Mustang. Be a part of the legend.
Today, Nortel Networks is changing the way businesses communicate.
Here come old Flat Top. He come grooving up slowly. He got Juju Eyeball.
He's saying,
I know you. You know me.
One thing I can tell you is you've got to be free.
Come together.
Bringing it all together with the true power of the internet.
Come together.
Nortel Networks.
Right now.
How the world shares ideas.
Over me.
Live on CBC, Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Labatt Blue. A whole lot can happen out of the blue. And by Ford. For now, forever.
Buffalo has just hit the ice. Leading 2-1. If you didn't know anything about hockey, think this was some kind of a cult show. Marina is rocking. There's no question about that. Two lineup changes tonight. If you've not heard, Rob Ray is in for Buffalo. That has nothing to do with the shenanigans at the end of game number three when Ty Domi was involved with Dominic Hasek and said Wayne Primo has a knee injury. He was in a collision with Chris King. Primo can't go, so Rob Ray gets the chance to suit up for the home side. Adam Mayer, a 20-year-old youngster who broke into the NHL playing his first ever game in the playoffs, scoring in that first ever game. He'll replace Derek King in the Toronto lineup. King is out. That's just Pat Quinn's decision. He didn't feel King was rolling. So the pressure is on Toronto. Keisha Adamchuk will sing to honor our neighboring nations as the Toronto Maple Leafs put it all on the line against the Buffalo Sabres tonight.
And now, join us in the singing of the Canadian and U.S. National Anthems along with 11-year-old Keisha Adamchuk from North Buffalo.
Here in the building tonight for this game, the Maple Leafs and the Sabres. There's Curtis Joseph. He has to come back with another of his big games to take it to 2-2 before going home for game five on Monday. Curtis Joseph for the Maple Leafs. The Leafs have to beat him 3 of 4 games now to win the series. That's a tall order. Come to center ice. Referees for the game will be Mark Fawcett, number 11, and Jerry Gregson, number 4. Gord Rossiger and Dan Shepney will work the line. Pekka, Murata, Ward, Smelik, and Zetnik starting for Buffalo. Juskevich, Harkov, and on the wings for Toronto, Bohannes and Thomas. And here comes Matt Sundin, the captain, to center ice. So the two captains get ready to start this one. We're underway. To center and shoots it in. On it quickly, Schmelik got it up on the boards. Sabres get it down across center ice and give chase. Murata, though, wasn't there ahead of Juskevich. Now this crowd, would you, on this Saturday night here in Buffalo, the Sabres couldn't stop it. It came off the boards like a bullet and all the way down the ice. Smellick. Turning the play is Smellick behind the goal. Again, he has to put it back to Shattuck. The Leafs in their first hand. But now, three of them get away to center. Up over the Leaf line, but the play is called because behind Hasek, the net has been moved.
Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs have made one lineup change for tonight. They have put Adam Mayer in, and this is his first shift, and you can see he gets a hold of Richard Smellick with a nice body check and knocks him into the net. That causes the whistle. And let's have a look at the Leaf lineup. We're going with the same six defensemen. Côté played more than any other defenseman in Game 3. And Adam Mayer will sit in there in Derek King's spot with Adams and Johnson.
Faceoff comes to the right of Curtis Joseph. Brown at center now for Buffalo. Sullivan won it for the Leafs. Lead pass gets to the line. Sullivan was moving up there, but it didn't get to him. Johnson fires it in there on the left side. Sullivan gets the zone. Comes in, takes the shot. Dumped it over in front, and the Sabres quickly turn it back. Three of them come to center. Rolled in on the right wing. Chetan feeding it back in front of the net. But Brown was tied up. He's still there behind the goal with Karpatsev on him. Chetan comes in to help. Karpatsev, the defenseman for Toronto, moved it away quickly. And the Leafs get out. Looking for that first goal. Dominic Hasek just slipping that one to the right. And the Sabres get going. Chetan's pass. Knocked away from inside the line. And there goes Gary Ball. He dumps it in. Hasek was out, but he couldn't stop it behind the goal. Juno trying to pick it up for Buffalo. At the line. Away with Juno. And three of them come up on the two Leaf defensemen. The pass gets waded through. And Ball, good back checking. Picked it off. Out to center of it. That's a chance. That's the first big scoring chance. And Joseph stopped him. Hero now for Toronto. Left it over the line for Berezin a little bit too far. Rasmussen again. In goes Juno. His pass. That was broken up. And cleared by Perreault. The Leafs want to make changes. And Ray was caught with that one.
Well, the Buffalo Sabres have to make one change, not on defense. McKee has really come into his own as a young defenseman on this Sabre team. But you're going to see Ray is in and Wayne Primo is out. Primo hurt his knee in the third period in Game 3. I talked to him this morning. He hopes to be back within a week. But he says it's pretty tender. So the tough guy, Rob Ray, will take Primo's spot.
The face-off to the right of Dominic Hasek. No shot for him yet. And no score. Nearing the three-minute mark, the puck is down the ice again. Yuskevich is coming back. And Ray is right out. He was hit by Grosik, and now the net behind Joseph is off. Let's see how long Canary do.
Well, the net's off again the second time in the first 3 minutes that a whistle has gone because the net is knocked off. That's a pretty good indication that both teams intend to get people without the puck going to the net. And the Buffalo Sabres have done this pretty well the entire playoff, and it's an area of the game for Toronto that they want them to improve. As you see Grosik hit the back of the net and knocked it off. Grosik was a healthy scratch for the last couple of games against Boston and the first couple against Toronto. A talented guy. Not always do you get it every night from him.
9 seconds to short of 3 minutes into the first period. In Game 4 in Buffalo. Pekka on again for the Sabres. Won the draw into the corner. Parada in there first. Shot it behind the goal, that's Sundin. Bohannes waited for it. Did get it out over the line, barely. Jimmick's quick pass. Through the center, the Leafs trying to stop Pekka. He's coming hard to the net. And Joseph stops him. A great burst of speed by
some things can't be explained, only experienced. Casino Niagara, this is the one.
June 3rd is the date of the Ontario election. If you haven't received your notice of registration card, bring the proper identification with you on election day and you can still register to vote. It's not too late to protect your right to vote. For further information, look for our ad in your daily newspaper or call us at 1-888-ONT-VOTE. That's 1-888-668-8683. Elections Ontario, keeping you informed.
No score. 3-11 into the first. Pekka just then with a great chance to open the scoring. And Joseph, his second big save of the period. Buffalo has tested him four times now. And the Leafs have yet to get a shot on Hashik. Sabres shoot it in. Joseph out of the net for Karpatsev. With it behind him. Berard fell. And Verana snapped it in front. Ward passed it back to him. Again, kept it in, a Ward shot. Joseph is busy here. Now Sundin is coming up. The pass gets down across center, and Thomas keeps going with it. And then it rolled too far from it. Out below the center. The two leagues got back in a hurry. Ward just shot it in, and that is it. Referees letting them go so far. Took one back. Dumped in by Toronto. Ohanis waiting for the bench on the change. Sabres shooting down the ice. Brown is up into the center. And that play keeps going. That is an icing call against Buffalo.
Well, the Buffalo Sabres really do have some guys that play on the forward line who can hit you. Watch this hit by 25 Barada on Steve Thomas. And the Sabre forwards throw many more checks into the Leaf forward. Wonder whether it's going to tell you a story. Last night we had arena football here in a Marine Midland Arena. All kinds of action, and under that gridiron, you have the ice. The glass is gone, the boards are padded. 11,000 fans last night. And so you can imagine, to get the ice ready for tonight, the four quarterbacks that played these two teams all played the CFL at one time.
Buffalo controls it on the faceoff, and Chetan feeds it ahead. Sabres double in. Brown is chasing it. And so is Sanderson. Sanderson was in deep. They took somebody on a stick. They wanted a penalty call. But the two referees are just watching this game develop now. And it's a good pace. Sabres looking for the first goal. Brown shot. Blocked by Joseph. Rebound. It goes behind the net. Another shot by Brown. Came close. And now the penalty is called. Sanderson is the player who is going to get the first penalty of this game.
You're right, Bob. It's goaltender interference as Sanderson tried to cut close to the net to pursue the puck to the right of Joseph and knock Joseph down. And I am sure with what went on in game three that the coaches have been instructed we're calling goaltender interference a little more carefully and closely than we did in the first three games. And you're going to see it coming up right here. He's in the crease and bumps him, and the referee makes the call, and the Leafs get a power play. There it is, the goaltender interference call. Joseph was still on the blue ice. And I think the referees have got a crackdown on both teams because there was a bit too much of that, I thought, in game three.
So Sanderson is gone for interfering with Curtis Joseph, and the Toronto Maple Leafs now go on the power play. And this is an area, in this game anyway, that the Leafs have to pick it up a bit. Penalty killing in the power play department.
Well, the special teams has been the difference in this series so far.
Carpenter very slow getting it going, and then the pass bounced over the stick. Carpenter trying it again. Stall for a bit. Sundin can't reach the pass. Hashik will play it. He's out of the net. Sundin skated by him. And it's cleared by Zuba. By Joseph. No hard done. And the Maple Leafs on the power play have yet to get near Hashik. 55 seconds into the first period.
Well, the shots are 8-1 Buffalo, and this is the first shot by the Leafs as Lonnie Bohannis unloads from about 49 feet out. A hard shot. Hasek wasn't sure where it was. He knew it hit him, but he looked behind him to see if it maybe trickled through. I think the Leafs have got to get some shots on this guy and then get somebody to the net. They let him off the hook in game three with not enough chances. And he'll sting you every time you do that.
No score. Buffalo has had 8 shots. What a start for Curtis Joseph. And that first one by Toronto. Harrison knocked it down. Went after it. Burrow gets chase. But the Sabres get it by Smellick to the line. And now it's picked up by Harrison. His pass to the Burrow. Hasek is out. And he's got five of Burrow. Did a 360 behind the net. Hasek did. It was a very light puck. Seconds left in the penalty. The Leafs roll it in. Down the wing. Matt Perreault got it back to the point. Coverley ahead with it. In there for Perreault again. Now Sullivan passes back. Shot Cote. Blocked by Dominic Hasek. The Leafs pass it around beautifully on that attempt to score. And Hasek makes the save.
Well, two things that make for a good power play or help contribute to a good one. One is you get some people in front of the net. The Leafs haven't done that very often very well this season, let alone this series. And second, that you recover loose pucks in the offensive zone. And the Leafs did on this little power play. And Cote gets a good hard shot as Sullivan, one of his skills is battling for the puck, no matter who it's against or how big they are. And how often does this little guy come up with it or cause a turnover? There was a great example right there.
Teams at full strength. They shot to the left of Dominic Hasek. Here we go. Puck slides behind the net as Barnes won the draw. Leafs try to forechecking. This is style now. Along the boards, out to the line.
Mike Harris will cut taxes to keep Ontario's economy strong. But what will Dalton McGuinty do to our economy? McGuinty's making billions in new spending promises with no plan to pay for them. We know what that means. Higher taxes, bigger deficits, lost jobs. We can't go back. Mike Harris, strong leadership. Dalton McGuinty, big spending, high taxes. He's just not up to the job. Authorized by the CFO for the Ontario PC Party.
You put away a bit of money. Not a fortune, but with each passing day, it grows. Every so often, you stop and think about it. You feel good. That's the beauty of saving. And when you buy Ontario savings bonds, you feel even better. Because you're investing in your future, your children's future, and Ontario's. Buy Ontario savings bonds. Competitive rates, 100% secure. Available everywhere. May 28th to June 18th.
Live on CBC, the one and only Hockey Night in Canada.
Nearing 8 minutes of play in the first. There is no score. Hasek will force the faceoff by smothering this one.
Dmitry Iskevich, who leads the Leafs in this series with a +4, makes a nice heads-up play in the neutral zone. There was a Buffalo Sabre in behind both Yuskevich and Markov, but Yuskevich read the pass. You saw that Saber just for a second and make the interception, and it was Sanderson. And Adams, who's given the Leafs, I think, some real good performances as the fourth center. He and Chatan are battling for the puck along the boards.
Faceoff, puck goes behind the net. And Markov was buffed before he could get a stick on it. Isn't he? He's another guy who can really wheel fast. Number 19 for Buffalo. Johnson, way down to Holzinger's stick. But the Leafs pick it up anyway and get it down to the Buffalo line. Rasmussen turning it center. Finding room on the boards to chop it in. There goes Juno. Boy, these Sabres are hitting all of them. Juno now. Juno on the boards, and he takes a hit back from Markov, but he gets the puck again. Juno slides it in front of the net. Johnson turns around with it. Coming out for Toronto and just fired it down the ice. It misses the net. And that's an icing call against the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Well, I think Buffalo's made it pretty clear that if the Leafs want to win this game, they're going to have to get into the trenches and fight the Buffalo Sabres physically. So far, it hasn't been much of a problem for Toronto. The big test is, can you do it shift after shift? And when you see Joey Juno start throwing checks, you know the Buffalo Sabres game plan is pretty clear as he roars right in and takes Markov out on the forecheck. If the Leafs are going to avoid a problem on the forecheck, they have to move the puck quickly to the defenseman, and the wingers have to get in position early so they're available and ready.
Echo won the draw, but the Leafs jumped on it and floated over in front of Joseph. Then Berard tried to hit Thomas, who was way up there near the Buffalo blue line. Right up. He shot it in. Joseph going to leave the net. Took a swing at it. Now he has to hustle back. And he did get back just in time. I'm not sure if he was ready for a shot or not. Would have been close, but the Leafs were there to pick it up.
It was the two captains, 27 in white, 13 in blue, and Pekka won the battle and got the puck right out in front to Dixon Ward, and Joseph with a great glove stop when he was already down, keeps the score at nothing, and Curtis Joseph so far gives you the impression he's in the groove.
For 9 minutes of the first period anyway, the Buffalo Sabres are handling the Maple Leafs. Shots are 9-2. Said. Here comes Beretta. He's nailed again. And the Leafs don't get it out right away. Now they move it to center. And it's shot into the Buffalo zone. Zipnis. Pulled away from the hit. Puck is knocked loose by Schmelik. And then cleared out by Schmelik. Down the ice. Toronto move up. No score. Approaching. Tomorrow in Texas, 2 o'clock Eastern.
You've seen the biggest movie of the year. Now get a load of this.
Yeah!
Our villains are cooler.
Talk to the hand because the face don't want to hear it anymore.
Our effects are more special.
We are sexy.
Yeah!
And our hero has the real force. Austin Powers, the spy who shanked me. Yoda this.
Gotcha!
Starts June 11th at theaters everywhere.
From the faceoff, the Sabres have to back up in their own zone, but the puck was a little high, and it's called again. The faceoff of the near the Maple Leaf blue line, just inside.
Gary Bulk with 3 points, a goal and 2 assists in this series. A valuable member of this Toronto Maple Leaf team this year. And who can ever forget his 2 goals, including the OT winner against Pittsburgh to eliminate the Penguins.
He's there now with Perreault and Barrison. Brown for Buffalo. Chatan on the right and Juno on the left. think that's Sanderson on the left side.
Had to change directions in a hurry after the turnover at the blue line occurred, and he fell, or he would have been able to walk in alone, as the Buffalo Sabres defense made an uncharacteristic giveaway as it looked like they were clearing the zone. Walk tries to wrap around and loses, and here's the problem. The key on a soft little pass into the middle, well read by Perreault, and there's the trip that cost Walk the chance.
Off to the right of Dominic Hushman. Only two saves to make so far in this first period. No score, 9:40 left. Matches again for the Maple Leafs, and Domi is parked at the boards to his left. Puck comes over in front for a brief second. Winger for the Maple Leafs in forechecking. Buffalo will get it out. Bruce Henry.
Nutritional energy in an advanced form. Like other meal replacements, it's engineered to give your body 16 micronutrients it needs and tastes great. Vector from Kellogg. Fuel up.
Flashback, a website unlike any other. A living video archive of the past 10 years. Connect through News World's homepage.
So now at 11:12 of the period, a power play for Buffalo.
He and Ray get together right here, and it comes out a holding penalty. Not too often you see these two guys get called for holding, but there's the hold as Domi pins Ray, and now the Buffalo Sabres with a power play. 5-for-17 in this series get a chance to go ahead.
Now that's what you call a hot power play.
Don Lieber, the assistant coach, is in charge of the power play, and it has worked to almost perfection in the playoffs.
Kiskevich shoots it from center. The Sabres will come back now and try to get organized and come after the Maple Leafs for the first goal of the game. 8:30 remaining in the first. Now here they come. Pekka dumps it in. Kiskevich hit hard on the boards in the corner, but not hard enough. Stop at the line by Schindler. Pekka sets it up. In the corner, he goes to the net. Shoots it in, and there's Curtis Joseph. He'll put it away. Stick style. to go. Holzinger gets the line, skates in perfectly, and slides it behind the net. We're out on the other side. Can he keep it in? Leafs are there, two of them. Decided he'd come out. There's Adams again. Another shot. Hasek stopped that easily. But he had to keep the puck moving on this power play for Buffalo. And the cup. Penalty coming up against Toronto. It's Buffalo. With the puck. And now, here comes the penalty.
Evan Adams is going to get it. It's a goaltender interference. And Hasek gets straight out of the net. Adams is getting ready for the back. Collision took place. This is nothing like being bothered in the crease. As Hasek comes out, and I guess you got to give him a penalty. He knocked him down. I don't even think Hasek saw him. But I don't think it was an attempt by Adams to do it. But nevertheless, as I mentioned earlier, they're calling these penalty a lot more strictly tonight. We've seen two already.
19 seconds remaining in the tie going penalty. So it's that margin of time with a 5-on-3. But the play just before that where Hasek decided he was going to race the lead player to the puck. And he came out about 12, 40, 45 feet. And then said, no, I'm going to lose this race. And he scampered back. And he did get back in time.
He, more than any other goalie in the league, will race out of the net 40, 50 feet if you think he can get the puck. He's a great skater. And it's one reason why he's an excellent goalie. He can recover. We know all about his balance in the goal race.
Substitution for the goaltender.
Faceoffs at center ice because on the penalty delay, Buffalo cheated on the substitution.
All right, Buffalo gets his own right away. Brown has a man in front of the net. Now he's covered.
Play without filing too many penalties, but they're strict on the goaltender.
So far, the penalties have been about goaltenders.
This one to a goaltender, Dominic Hasek. Minor penalty for interference, and Groshek will be in the box to serve. 5:25 left to play the first period. No score. Leafs win the draw. Quick shot. Hasek had the angle on that. Ferrari just flicked it wrist style. And he catches the goalie, maybe on the wrong foot. But not so. Battle on the boards. Leaf player down. And Pekkanen, he broke away. Now he will move. As the Sabres bring it in. Smack. Guarded over in front. The Leafs pick it up. Lead pass to Sundin. Didn't see it in time. Joseph with a high catch. 4:55 left in the period. Toronto, power play. And up they come. Sundin carries this time. Oh, what a bad pass. It's Pekka coming in along. Right in. Stop. He was stopped by Berard, who made a beautiful effort to come back and stop Michael Pekka. Sundin this time to the right wing with it. Down to the left side. Johannes waits. Johannes again, moving up a step or two. Johannes trying to feed it behind the net. Thomas gets it on the boards to the line. Into Thomas. He waits. He's caught. And the shot is blocked. Bernard farted all right, but way on Holzinger. Down to Korchek. Offside that pass. And they'll bring it back inside the Leaf blue line with 41 seconds left in the penalty that was called on Dominic Hasek.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If you had to nominate a Leaf defenseman to recover when it looked like the opposition was getting a breakaway, it would be Berard. Peck is not a great skater, but he's a very good one. And Berard catches him with a brilliant defensive play at the last minute as Michael Pekka jumped on a Sundin turnover and nearly turned it into a shorthanded goal.
That is definitely the strength of Brian Berard, that skating ability. He's a beautiful skater, and he demonstrated for you right there with an effort to get back and stop Pekka and possibly the first goal of the game. Good play by Berard. 4 minutes left in the period. 35 seconds on the Leaf power play. Hammerlick feeds it in the wing. Cote comes to the net. Hasek made the stick save. Shot is tipped on the ice. And that's it. Another break. Turn back.
Drops it off to the boards. Larner feeds it behind the net. Sabres pressure again. Sabres leading 1-0 and looking for more. And they're good at it. Elliot Poe is behind the net. Shoots Juno out front. They hit a skate. Juno again. Backs it up a bit. Larner was hit. And the Leafs move it out.
You're a friend in need with a 99 Ford F-150 XLS Supercab 4x4. Only $399 a month with air, auto, and more. Or choose an F-150 Supercab 4x2 with standard four doors for only $318 a month. Either way, get a genuine Roots leather jacket with any new Ford F-Series lease or purchase. Let your Ontario Ford and Mercury dealers help you get yours now.
It would sure do me good to do you good. Let me help.
Lots of long-distance companies let you save money when you call at night. But have you seen what they're charging you during the day?
At Sprint Canada, there's no difference between night or day. You get the same low rate no matter when you call.
For $4.95 a month, call anytime, night and day to anywhere in Canada and pay just 10 cents a minute. Call 1-800-THE-MOST today.
Night, day, it's all the same to us.
The Leafs complained, came out of the crease on the icing as if to play the puck. And that now, this year, means they waved the icing off. But for some reason, they didn't. And the Leafs, are, as a result, will have a face-off in their own end to the left of Curtis Joseph. And the linesman heard all about it, but wouldn't change his mind.
Buffalo 1, Toronto nothing. 1:55 remaining in the first period. Ward got the goal. Arada gives chase in the Leafs zone. So does Putnam. Fired goal, slides it away from in front of the net. The Leafs get it out to center, but the Sabres now are picking it up and checking more carefully, more closely. There's Thomas centering it. Hundy missed it. And he was open on the short side. Arada feeds it behind the net. Thomas is in first. Sundy was slow to move for it. Position in there, and he got caught by Ward, who slapped it out. But he was caught in time himself. Maple Leafs Sundin didn't see the pass behind. There's it coming again. Arada made a good move. Passed it over in front. And Joseph saved one that time from Sanderson, who quickly snapped it right at the far corner. And Joseph made a big save.
Well, the Leafs objected to the fact that Michael Peck kind of at the time the whistle, and look at the cut on Gordy Brassinger's forehead. We have we've got a penalty coming up here to somebody. As Barry Gregson sprints and he gets a roughing call, and I think it's against the Leafs. But Gordy Brassinger's got a nasty cut on the forehead. We have a standby linesman, Wayne Bonney, and he may be forced to come in.
Linesman Brassinger injured and receiving attention.
There's one place you'll always.
Thomas is in the box now for the Maple Leafs, and he was caught for this roughing.
Well, there was a skirmish. There's Gordy Brassinger, Jim Picciatelli, the Buffalo trainer, trying to patch him up. And the question now is, can he finish the period 1:08? They're going to put a bandage on it. They'll have a closer look to it in between periods. And there's Gordy Brassinger. Surely he's not going to do it with a goalie against the forehead. But he was really bleeding there. And anyway, Thomas picks up a roughing penalty well after the whistle had gone. So with 1:08 left, the Leafs are back into the penalty count.
1-0 Buffalo. Power play now, Buffalo's goal, shorthanded. And the Leafs have the extra man. Ward scored it.
Last minute of play in this period.
Woolley fired a hard pass into the corner. Buffalo spread out.
shot in.
The net is off. That's the second time behind Hasek. With 30 seconds left in the period.
Perreault just fired the Buffalo defenseman into the net after he was holding him and bothering. He didn't get a penalty, but Perreault didn't like it. And at the end of it, he just gives the Buffalo defenseman Smelik a shove right here. Stu Barnes, who was back checking into the crossbar, and the net comes off.
And the faceoff is going to be inside the line with the Leafs killing a penalty. That is a little bit of a help for Toronto.
The Leaf penalty killing has been pretty impressive so far, but you can't keep taking penalties to get away with it against this power play of Buffalo.
30 seconds left. Shots are 13-6 in favor of Buffalo. They win the draw. Again. Slapped on the boards and Hutton stopped it. Where will he? To the line, a good shot. No shot though. 4 seconds left. They have a goal now with it. And they won't get a shot. The tag turns as the horn goes to end the first period here at the Marine Midland Arena in Buffalo, New York. And the Sabres got a shorthanded goal. And Don Cherry is standing by for our first intermission in the coach's corner. Ward, his fifth of the playoffs, from McKee and Hasek, the goalie, at 16:15. After one, Buffalo leads 1-0.
Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Had enough?
Let's go.
Anything you can be, I can be greater.
First stop.
Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
I'm not stopping.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
From the producer of Clear and Present Danger.
Oh, no.
The general's daughter.
Why was she murdered?
And the director of Con Air.
Profit, revenge, jealousy, or plain old homicidal mania.
John Travolta.
Were you aware of Elizabeth's extracurricular activities?
Nothing is gained by my involvement.
You'd better start thinking about your career.
And you better start thinking about yours.
You've been warned.
The General's Daughter. Starts Friday, June 18th.
Perhaps you're wondering about the new emissions testing program called Ontario's Drive Clean. Well, just to clear a few things up, when you get your notice, all you have to do is take a simple emissions test at a Drive Clean facility. The test is fast, fair, and reliable. You and your car will soon feel a lot better because Drive Clean will cut pollutants from vehicles by up to 22%. So get the test and get going. Ontario's Drive Clean. It's for the air we breathe.
They must have been at the concert.
Let's hope that's all it is.
Randy Travis live in concert June 23rd at Casinorama. Now there's even more excitement.
Coach's Corner with Don Cherry. Brought to you by your Alliance Tire Professionals.
At Uniroyal, in order to make a point about our Nail Guard tires, we added a few to our test track. Nail Guard tires, designed to seal 90% of tread punctures instantly, permanently. Nail Guard from Uniroyal, peace of mind guaranteed.
What do you think?
Well, you know, the guys are home watching that game last night, that great game last night.
They're letting them away with war. One of the best games I've seen in the playoffs in 10 years. So the guys come down tonight and say, hey, we're going to have war too. Let them play. He's calling chintzy penalties. They're chintzy penalties. You know they're chintzy penalties. Say they're chintzy penalties.
Absolutely. Well, there's a run on penalties for sure. And the thing I noticed was Gregson wanted to let him go. He let Chetan away. There was a holding the stick on Chetan. There were two elbows.
How about them looking
at the guy at the other end? So there's where two referees
well,
guys doing one
you
thing.
You know, how about Johnson when he falls down? He takes a look over and Chetan turns around. When you're a referee, doesn't that embarrass you when a guy, please, sir? You know when I first saw that? 1980 in the World Tournament. I saw, I'm not going to say, over in there. That's when I Oh, look at me, I'm hurt. Hey, I'll forget it. What's happened with Toronto, what's happened with Toronto, one of the main things is that their forwards, Toronto forwards, are getting nailed all over the place. And then when the Buffalo forwards come down there, they have no fear of God in them at all. Even Yastrevich is not hitting anymore. Maybe it's because he's afraid of a penalty. But I think we got a couple of shots here. You touch the puck in the Buffalo zone, you get hit. I think we got it. Watch, you just touch, it's their main thing. Well, I don't know what's around here anyhow.
You think even in the last couple of games that's been the problem for Toronto?
What was that one? I think this here coming up here, he gets nailed. See, they run at them anyhow, and he goes behind the net. As soon as they get him, they run them into the boards. I think the puck comes around the side here. Watch. Now, he touches the puck, the defense, bang. I mean, that's the way you got to play defense. Every time the forward touch, you got to hit him, and that's what they're not doing in Toronto.
You know, Toronto had a bad second period in the last game. I know Pat Quinn said, I don't know what it is, but now we're going to have a good second period tonight. Maybe we're looking ahead. I don't know.
You know, I got to talk about that Colorado series again. I've never seen Pat Roy. I call him Pat Roy now because my grandson, 4 years old, told me to say Pat Roy. Anyhow,
Pat Roy to say Pat Roy.
Oh, Pat Roy. I'm getting mixed up. Patrick
Roy. By the way, let's make it. Can I interrupt? I know you don't have a lot of time, but just to make it official, Patrick has told me through the director of media relations he does not have Tourette syndrome. I don't know where
Oh, good.
It. My mistake, and I'm sorry I misled you, but he definitely doesn't have it.
But he still twitches a lot.
Yes, he does.
Anyhow.
Because of the sweat.
Is that it?
He told me that's the reason.
Okay, the sweat. That's what I said, and you brought up that other thing.
I don't know where I thought he had it. I really, but all I'm wrong, and I'm sorry I was wrong. Patrick didn't.
Oh, good.
Was misled, which is a lot of people. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Colorado, I've never seen a guy like Patrick Waugh. I've never seen a guy, and he wants to win. He doesn't care what he says. He says our centers are playing lousy. They're getting outplayed, and you want to score on Belfort, just put it up high. Where did Drury's shot go? High. He doesn't care. I've never seen a guy like that. And I'll tell you one thing. Whoever's going to play then, they might not have any players left. I mean, that is hockey last night. Not like tonight. You got to hit. You got to bang in the playoffs. And the referees last night let him go.
What do you think of Hatcher getting hit?
Well, here's the thing. You know, many times I've said this about this icing. He thought it was an icing. I don't understand it. But watch it here. Watch, he thinks it's an icing, and Deadmarsh comes in. Now watch, it is icing. I think it was a follow-through. But watch him hesitate as he gets it. See, he thinks, bang. And watch this here. You know, I hate those icings. I'll tell you, look at that. Watch, he gets in again. You know, it is unbelievable. When are they going to stop? Why don't they have it automatic? Did it speed up the game? You know, there's two guys I remember that there's been numerous guys hurt badly. Al MacInnis, but two I remember, Jimmy Watson, when he was in Colorado, he had his leg broken in 17 places, never played again. Pat Peake, remember, God love him, Pat Peake, he had 19 goals at Christmas. He was finally getting everything ready. Breaks his heel, never to play again. You know, they're worried about a few punches here and there. This is death. When somebody gets killed and a broken back or a broken neck, it's going to happen. And I hated that because I had to go back and I wasn't a good skater. And before, the guys used to peel away a little. But not now. Bang, they hit you just like that, and it's too bad.
Even in the first period, as Harry pointed out, when Dominic left the crease, now somebody may let down. You're right.
Yeah.
We got about a minute and a half.
Okay. You know, there's a few things we've got coming in hockey now. Before it was elbow, stick, and everything. We got a new thing coming now. Take the puck and use that as a weapon. Now, right off the bat, everybody thinks Zidnik was after. We can show it. Zidnik was after Perreault. He wasn't. Watch. Now, this is a power play. You think he's doing that? Watch him after Johnson. He's after Johnson for some reason. See that? Mm-hmm. Tried. I've said, you know, I've done many dirty things in my life, but there's one thing I never did was try to hit a guy on the foot, and that's what he tried to do. Now, here's another one. We got a little thing. You know, Lindy Ruff's a good guy. I really like him. He come up the hard way, you know, and the whole thing like that. But he's getting carried away with himself. You know what I'm talking about? And it happens in the National Hockey League. You get a few wins, your team's winning, you get all full of yourself and everything like this. And you start saying things like this. like saying your goaltender's dead. Watch, he says this on the bench. Now watch what he says to Joseph. This is when he turns and he's mad. Look at it. Your goaltender's dead. He's dead. He's gone.
You wouldn't say that when
I would never say that ever. Never say that. And he saw him there. Now, goes out here. It's a face-off in the end. Watch the face. Watch Dixon Ward, what he does. And everybody knows you shoot high. Watch on the goaltender. No way to win. He just drifts it up high. Boom. Toes at his head. There's no doubt about it. Now watch when Joseph skates off, says something to him. There's no doubt in my mind he shot at his head. So the old story is, when you shoot at their head, the next shot's got to be right along the ice. Do you remember where the goal went in? Mm-hmm. Right along the ice. And you know, what gets me is this whining about putting players on at the end. Ruff had the last change. If you don't have your tough guys, don't whine about it. You know, it's an awful thing to say about an elder guy, an older guy. No, excuse me, Pat, an older guy, respected guy, coach of the year, from a guy that's only been in the league 2 years. The guy should mind his own manners. You know, it's a sad thing when
did
I see
it.
A, I have never yelled at a goal.
No,
guy
no,
like,
no, but did you ever say something, go in, heat, right after the moment, heat of the moment?
I said it, but I never ever said coaching in the National Hockey League is tough enough without having coaches pick on one another. The guy's only been in the league 2 years. Don't get too full of yourself.
Don Cherry on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Coach's Corner on CBC. Brought to you by your Alliance Tire Professionals.
At Uniroyal, in order to make a point about our Nail Guard tires, we added a few to our test track. Nail Guard tires, designed to seal 90% of tread punctures instantly, permanently. Nail Guard from Uniroyal, peace of mind guaranteed.
Buffalo playoff tickets. Who's got tickets? I need some tickets here, folks. I need five. But I'll take one.
Please release me. Let me go. Release me. Darling, let me go.
Okay, Cup, C-U-P, it was supposed to be here 3 days ago.
Not Stanley Zup.
Listen to this, okay? Okay? You hear that? That's 20,000 screaming people that are going to tear me apart, okay? They're going to tear me apart. Not to mention 20 big guys with big sticks.
You tear!
Okay, thank you very much.
Ho, ho, ho.
Goodbye.
Hey, the yellow cup, it belongs to you, buddy.
Stanley Cup, come here.
Next time, send it FedEx and be absolutely sure.
Okay, calm down.
A powerful story. They are making millions of dollars that changed the game of hockey forever.
I put together the finest team.
The NHL.
Yeah, yeah.
The Gemini Award-winning Network. Sunday on CBC.
There's Dixon whispering to himself. He thinks I'm going at his head. Right along the ice, Dixon Ward. The North Dakota journalism major joins Scott O for an analysis of the first period.
Dixon Ward gets the shorthanded goal for the Buffalo Sabres. Dixon, it's not often you can count on beating Curtis Joseph from that far out. Is that the kind of break in which the game can turn?
Well, I don't know if the game can turn on one play, but it definitely gave us a little bit of an edge there. We thought we played a pretty good first period, and Curtis was making some big saves for him. So for us to sneak one by him gives us a little bit of confidence going into the second.
It's pretty clear you intend to hit the Leafs at every opportunity. Can you play that way for three periods?
I think so. I think that we've played like that for most part of the playoffs, and anytime we keep our energy level up and and really try to keep our shift short and roll them over, I think we'll be fine.
Thanks.
All right, thanks, Scott.
Up to the Minute. Brought to you by Ford. For now, forever.
It's easy to get through life with a shrug and just say, who cares? That showing a little compassion just shows you're out of date. But to all of you who really do care, that would rather break your heart than break your word, we'd just like you to know that in addition to steel and rubber, we put heart and soul into every car we make. Ford. For now, forever.
Colorado Avalanche Dallas Stars resume their series tomorrow. It was a practice session today. There's Bob Hartley in conversation saying, what I told Ozalinch to do was give it to Drury and then for him to go high. Perfect advice from Hartley. That's Valerie Kamensky. Good news for the Avs fans. He will play. He missed game three with a bad wrist, or game four, I should say. Milan Hayduk, however, with the broken collarbone, is through for the Stanley Cup playoffs. So a tough blow in that regard. They will have Matt Tkachuk back. Will Dallas? We'll have that game tomorrow afternoon at 2 ET.
Up to the Minute. Brought to you by Ford. For now, forever.
To produce the ultimate hockey player, you need the right combination of power, speed, agility, and CCM. Because at CCM, we've spent the last 100 years perfecting every component down to the finest detail with only one goal in mind. CCM, the hockey company.
He was part of the animal group.
To study the mind of a convicted killer.
Are you a murderer?
Oh, yeah. A psychiatrist.
If you don't talk to me, I can't help you.
Is prepared to risk everything. Academy Award winner Anthony Hopkins.
Never had control. You only thought you had it.
Academy Award winner Cuba Gooding Jr.
He's leading me into the jungle.
He's leading you.
Instinct.
What are you up to? Therapy.
Starts Friday, June 4th.
Lots of long-distance companies let you save money when you call at night. But have you seen what they're charging you during the day?
At Sprint Canada, there's no difference between night or day. You get the same low rate no matter when you call.
For $4.95 a month, call anytime, night and day to anywhere in Canada and pay just 10 cents a minute. Call 1-800-THE-MOST today.
Night, day, it's all the same to us.
Live on CBC, Hockey Night in Canada. Brought to you by Ford. For now, forever.
Buffalo Sabres are up 2-1 in the series, 1-0 in game four here at Marine Midland Arena. The shots in that period, 13-6, scored Brosker's fine. He's just gone back on the ice as well. Niagara Falls is 15 minutes away, where Rick Lee won two Memorial Cups. And Rick Lee is now with Scott Oak.
Rick, they double you up in shots in the first period, get a shorthanded goal. What are your concerns after the opening 20 minutes?
Well, I think we were ready to play, and obviously they were ready to play also. And what we have to do is we have to stick with our plan. We got to stay out of the penalty box. We can't take needless penalties and put the onus on our penalty killing. We got to stick to our plan and just keep working, keep the feet moving, and make sure we get it by their defense and force them to play in their end.
Are you happy with the way your team is answering their physical challenge?
We don't have a problem at all with our team. I mean, we've answered the bell all year, and that's not a problem for our team. We just have to keep working. I mean, a lot of people didn't expect us to be here in the beginning, so we've got great contributions from all our players, and we just have to dig a little deeper.
Thanks, Rick.
My pleasure.
Thank you, Scott and Rick. Buffalo Sabres have scored a power play goal in every playoff game. So a big situation for Toronto right now as we go back up to Bob Cole and Harry Neal. Bob.
Thank you, Ron. And 52 seconds left in the Leaf penalty as we start the second. 1-0. The Buffalo Sabres are ahead of the Maple Leafs. Sabres move up. Johnson forechecking on the penalty kill. He needs a big turn to get back as the Sabres get in deep. Will he center it up? Wilson got the stick out to intercept that one. Jitnik at the line, and it's lost by Chetan, and down the ice he goes. Jitnik is the man back. 20 seconds left in the Leafs penalty. Pass on an open wing. And the Leafs pick it up. Holt shoots it away again. On the net by Jitnik. Willie hits it ahead. Leafs kill the penalty now. Thomas is back on with his shot. That's blocked. But the Sabres are in deep after it. He'll get behind the net. Toronto, move it out. Pass back off the board. Thomas had to stop. Then he poked it ahead. Holt shot. That's blocked. Thomas is on it. Thomas gave it away in there. Trying to beat the man and go around the net. Sabres cut back. It's Brown. Gets in. Side all the way to the line, and Brown has it again, trying to center it this time out himself. Centered it, and the shot by Pekka didn't miss by much. Pekka is bumped by Coverle. Bolt fell, put the stick in there though. Chetan comes out, he leaves it. Great pressure by Buffalo. They're all over the Maple Leafs here. Chetan again, and on it, broke a stick, and the Leafs give it up to center ice. Stretch on that one.
That's the best stop Dominik Hasek has made since the last round of the playoffs against the Boston Bruins on a labeled shot. You're going to see the pass from Barrison right here to Thomas, and he just wires it, and the puck's rolling. And he keeps it down, and it was a great stop. The Leafs' penalty killing has been much improved tonight. One of the reasons is they're getting right out on Woolley and Jitnik. Jitnik is number one in penalty and power play points in these playoffs, and there's a good example right there. And Woolley is tied for second. They have 18 combined power play points.
Face off at the Sabre zone. Sundin won it. That's Bohannes on the left. Domi is on there now, and it's offside. Domi got hit with a high stick on that play.
Well, Thomas came out of the penalty box and couldn't get off the ice. So he played a long shift as the man coming off, and that's why Domi's on the Sundin line right now. Kai Domi takes one right in the noodle from Mike Pekka. And he'll stay out there as the right winger with Bohannes and Sundin. And I don't think it's any secret in the fact that Matt Sundin has got to play a lot better than he played in the first period if the Leafs are going to prolong this series or take a shot at winning it.
Leafs looking a little weary at times in that first period. And Buffalo were full of vinegar. Domi is in with a hit. Puck comes to the side of the goal. The Leafs scramble for it. Domi was hit back then. He comes again. Domi needing Domi took that stick a little high on a check by Pekka a little while ago. Now Pekka lined him up at center ice and knew what he was going to do. Took him about 5 seconds to get there, and then he nailed Berard. Boy, he's tough.
Mike Pekka, boy. What happens on these open ice hits for Pekka is he arrives about a stride sooner than you think he's going to. You think you're all right, and you look up, takes a hit right there from Domi. But here we come right here. Now watch Pekka. He gets the angle, and then he gets right there about a stride before Berard thought he was going to get there. That's a real knack, and a skill not many players in this business have, the ability to throw an open ice check.
Doesn't mind it at all. Apparently he loves it.
He weighs about 175 pounds.
I know. I saw him in the room the other day, and really, he's a slight hockey player, but tough as nails. It's scooped out to center ice. Groshen. In on the wing was Rasmussen.
Thank you.
go up the middle with it, and Holzinger is standing right there and walks in all alone on Joseph. Steve Sullivan wants the long pass to break out of the zone, did not check to see if anyone was in the passing lane.
Very,
very tough to come back on him. And they're up 2-0 now. Toronto trying to get it back. Ashik to save on the short side, Alperazin. Ball Kazim with a hit. Juno scooped it out, and there go the centers again. Three of them are coming after two Leafs defensemen. In on the wing, centered by Groshan. Took it away, and the Leafs got a 3-on-2. They move it up to the line where McKee chopped it down. Harrison, he missed it. Asmussen firing it in again, and Markov will take it. They're calling Pujo. They're on Joseph.
Here's something to look out for this summer. New Boomerang.
A great new spin on lemonade.
New Boomerang.
Refreshing taste.
Refreshing price.
Boomerang.
Boomerang.
Right now at your beer store.
Boomerang.
A new spin on the taste of lemonade.
Now, rediscovering Canada has never been easier. Because Chrysler is celebrating their 15th anniversary as Canada's best-selling minivan. Now until June 10th, you can get any Chrysler minivan with all the features you want. At 0% purchase financing. And here's a reminder of some of the options that come at no extra cost. For details, your free events travel planner, and a chance to win a dream vacation, see your neighborhood Chrysler retailer now.
Holzinger making it 2-0 for the Buffalo Sabres on this one.
Well, this was an attempted breakout pass by Sullivan. Holzinger forgot presented with the puck and put it in.
Unassisted, of course. Holzinger is third of the playoffs. 2:51 the time. Toronto in a hole against the Sabres. And Sundin is offside on that rush as Thomas passed it into him.
Well, this is a gut test for the Leafs. They need the next goal, and they need it pretty quickly. And this Buffalo team, one of the better teams at defending the lead. And if you get a little careless and take too many chances, it'll be in your net. So this is a real test for the Leafs.
Face off at the line, won by Sundin. They'll get it in, but the Sabres are coming back fast. Shoot it down the ice, no icing, it's been waved off. Côté hurrying back as Joseph informed him on the way off. Now Côté, up to Sundin. Mohanis right behind him, he goes to the other side, and Coverley misfired.
Joseph, well behind the play, had more than just a conversation. Murata still talking to Berard. Here it is right here. Murata gets it. Oh, he gets the old separator. Joseph, he doesn't like it. Makes a comment or two. The referee, you can see him looking at it. Let's it go.
The faceoff will come now inside the Buffalo line. To the left of Hashik.
Ty Domi just went over and had a little chat with Rob Ray. Let's see if it was a friendly one or a hostile conversation.
Mark for the second. Long shot. Doesn't reach the net. couldn't get near it. Notice this one. Domi got it out front, and the shot is blocked.
Go! road. Look at the light.
It's so beautiful.
Most imaginative.
Look, I'm a beautiful butterfly.
Number one family film of the year.
That, my friends, is the sound of a
clown. Out here in the field.
A Bug's Life.
It's a huge hit.
On sale today.
Buy one of these four Disney videos and you can receive instantly a free drink or chips up to $2 in value. See in-store coupon for details.
Time remaining is 13:40. Might seem like an eternity to the Maple Leafs, and they need an eternity now. They're down 4-0 to the Buffalo Sabres, and the Sabres are not showing any sign of hanging back. Keep coming. Rada just missed out behind the goal. The boards. The power play. Stand by for that.
Whatever your project, Canadian Tire can help it take shape. Canadian Tire, still the right place to do it.
There's Dixon Ward. It'll be tripping, I think.
A little one of those excuse me trips where he just put his stick down and not saying he didn't trip, but it wasn't a deliberate attempt right here. He gets it. Actually, it looked like Sundin stepped on his stick. The Leafs get a power play, and they need something good to happen because not much has tonight.
They need something good to happen, Harry. Over and over. They're down 4 goals. And the Sabres are playing a good hockey game. In their own zone, and on the attack. Coming after the Leafs and rushes. Here might be another one. A little bit too far for Brown to catch it before Coverley got it. Côté around the net. Groshek in for checking. Bumped the goalie a little bit. May continues to center ice. And the Leafs get the zone. Can't get a shot at Hasek. Cannot beat this Buffalo defensive core. Groshek at the center. Parted in wide of the Leafs. Sabres are changing. Case pass. Sullivan crossed the ice again inside his own line. And then it's kneeled into the left of Dominic Hasek. Nobody could center it. Sullivan chased it. The Sabres now shoot down the icing again. Icing is waved off for Joseph. He comes out to play it ahead quickly. Deep pass by Carter. There's it. Cuts for the net. Right in. Shot is stopped by Hasek. Just took the angle away from him. Jammed the pads. And the puck was right into his pads. In the corner, Pekka reaches the spot. Can't get it. Goes around the net where McKee takes over. And he just takes a long shot in one. Down the ice. Penalty time, 28 seconds. Ward in the box. Leafs trying to get something going. To the net, shoots, hit a stick Short pass to Johnson went by. Off his stick. Then he's in to take a hit. Looks for the puck. Gets it loose. And then fell. Rosas came out. Arctic again coming out for Buffalo. He was met quickly, so he shot it high on the glass. And now the ice. Just past the halfway mark of the second period. Johnson stopped in his tracks and hit. Sundin.
Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Introducing the all-new 225 horsepower Acura TL. Nothing else can touch it. Acura, designed with purpose, driven by passion.
That's gotta hurt. You see, Mike Smith came to us a couple of months ago with his dream of running with the Bulls in Spain. He was quite serious. So we made a couple of suggestions and, well, now look at him. Don't look back, Mike. Don't look back. Introducing a new way of borrowing. The Scotia Total Equity Plan. Get what you want out of life.
Curtis Joseph's been abandoned by his team. He has played a pretty good hockey game, but he has had to put up with quality chances on ones like that. Many of them giveaways by the Leafs. And here is Rhett Warner showing you exactly how to play defense in the National League on a dangerous customer. And Matt Sundin can't get much going tonight.
He didn't even think about playing the puck on that rush by Sundin. Jose, and slide it up, folks. There's another two-on-one coming. Rasmussen coming up. The shot off Joseph Blocker. Now there's Virata in there, forechecking. But hits again. Sundin tries it. Knocked away from him. Fights for it on the boards. Does get it loose in front. And the shot by Thomas Blocker. 8:59 left in the second period, and it's 22-10 in shots now.
Son, one day, this could all be yours. But till then, I still get to drive it.
Chevy Silverado. It has a more powerful V8 than any top-selling Ford or Dodge pickup. It even has a bigger extended cab than Ford F-150 and Dodge Ram.
So you'd really give me the Silverado?
Well, you might have to fight your sister for it.
The new Chevy Silverado. It's the truck. The Motor Trend Truck of the Year.
Closed captioning of this program is brought to you by Chevrolet. Chevrolet, tried, tested, and true.
Well, there are two Buffalo babes that are obviously very happy and feel they're going to go to the Stanley Cup Final. Well, they're on the road now, but still lots of hockey left of this. Just past the halfway mark. Period. It's 4-0 Sabres, and Hasek has not been too busy, not at all.
Well, he's made a few good stops, but he looks under control. You'd never know he was hurt. Not nearly as acrobatic as we normally see him. The Sabres have taken advantage of home ice here in the latter part of the schedule. The last seven home games, plus the first six in the playoffs, this being the seventh, the Sabres are 12-1 at Marine Midland Arena and looks definitely like it's going. going to be 13-1 after this one.
Leafs have had about 11 shots in the hockey game. Had the number of the Buffalo Sabres. The Sabres are ahead 4-0. McKee, a little touch pass from center to Holzer. He made two or three good moves in there to get away from three Leaf players. That was hit, but got the puck in deep. Buffalo skate around with it, all the way to the line, and now, you know, the weight. So Holzinger brought it in. Banked it off the board behind the net for Rasmussen. He's bumped. Can't pick it up again. There's another giveaway. That's blocked this time. Toronto trying to get it going. Had to stop, ripped the shot to a crowd, and Joseph saw that all the way somehow and stopped it.
Well, the Leafs got trapped at the offensive blue line on a giveaway, and the Buffalo Sabres jumped on it. Their transition game is among the better ones in the league. Here goes Rob Ray. He's going to be the guy who wants to get this pass. He's in the clear, but you can see that Michael Groshek overskated the puck. Let's have a look at the three goals that have put the Leafs in deep trouble here in the second period. Sullivan up the middle to Holzinger. It's 2-0. And then a pass here. Rob Ray tips it in between his legs. It's 3. And then this shot here and the rebound by Sanderson makes it 4.
And the puck ending up off that faceoff on top of the net behind Curtis Joseph. So the play was stopped again. You saw those three goals when the Ruffs team put together. They came in 2 minutes and 35 seconds. The first two in 22 seconds. Bang, bang. 2:51 and 5:04.
Well, they got three goals in game three, Buffalo did here, in 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the second period. So the second period has been disastrous for the Leafs so far in this round in Buffalo.
After the 5:04 goal, it came at 5:26. That's the 22 second thing, but 2.5 minutes, just like that, the Sabres are way out front, 4-0. Goal in the first by Dixon Ward. That was a short-handed goal. Toronto up with it. Chris Kent trying to jam it in. Keeps it along the goal line and cuts it out. High stick made contact. It's okay, the lead player.
Thomas, and Chatan really doesn't get a lot on it. His son Dean's kind of half bothering from behind.
You have to see his 24th birthday, and what a talent. Great speed, good shot, good instinct. Joseph coming up big again right there. You're right, his team. Nothing to do with himself in this period. He has been very, very steady. In the first period, made some big stops.
And now in this second period, same thing. Pat Quinn is a reluctant coach as far as pulling goaltenders. And he's got no reason to take Joseph out because he's playing poorly. But I'm sure he's thinking, you know, if I put Healy in and save Joseph from going through the rest of this game, which may get worse by the look of it, he may be better, in a better frame of mind, when they go back to Toronto for game five. And he may do it after the intermission, where Healy gets a chance to stretch in the dressing room and get a little skate before he starts. I don't know, but I'm sure he's thinking.
6:14 away from that intermission now. Sabres comfortable, very comfortable. On the first game in Toronto, 5-4. The Leafs came back with a 6-3 win. And here comes Brown again. Joseph stopped that pass out to Sanderson, who's in front. Shatan again, turning.
By Sanderson, who's got one of the best shots in the league. Beautiful pass by Shatan to Sanderson and Joseph Noho. A pulling shot.
Second goal of the period for Sanderson. This one comes at 14-10. And it's a 5-0 lead.
This is one home, his second of the game and third of the playoff score by number 80, Jeff Sanderson.
Into his own in this series after floundering around, not doing very much. 3 points in three games, and he's got three more tonight.
Shatan, the only assist on the goal by Sanderson, his second of this game, and he set him up for the first one. He and Brown did. That's the goal that made it 4-0. This is the goal that makes it 5-0. Johnson's pass inside his own line. Sullivan comes to center and shoots it in wide to Hasek. Johnson down the net, center, Hasek down. Puck stays out. Coverley shot. Hasek is out of the net. Knocked it away behind the goal. The Leafs cause a little disturbance in there now. Hasek goes it off the short side. Buffalo now take over and go down. Rasmussen cuts for the goal. Stays in there looking for it. It'll be Berard. Takes a hit from Rasmussen. Sullivan gets as far as center. That's all. Here's Johnson. He rolled it over in front of the net. And the Sabres are back. They don't clear it. Sullivan comes in. Shoots. Missed on the backhand. And then he was upended. And there's going to be a penalty as Sullivan was dumped after taking that backhander. When we come back, the Leafs will go out of power.
Summer.
How come you're not going?
Only you and my grandfather go every 30 seconds.
Adam Sandler is...
Do that thing I taught you the other day. That's my boy.
Big Daddy.
Can I have a nightlight?
Big Daddy.
There you go.
Opens everywhere June 25th.
Currently we're somewhere out west looking for a shinny ring.
Gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
Yeah. First goal gets the cup.
That's gonna hurt.
Don't you just love playoff hockey?
A whole lot can happen. Out of the blue. Labatt blue.
CBC, your network for the 1999 Pan Am Games from Winnipeg. The rise and fall of the movie moguls. Hollywoodism, June 6th.
Dixon Ward in the penalty box for the Sabres. Leaf set to go on the power play. Here's Sabres general manager Darcy Begeer. Darcy, how do you account for this explosion?
Well, I think our guys really knew how important this game was to keep home ice advantage, and I think that's the biggest thing.
Do you trace this back to last game?
I do. I think we finally started to play our own game in the second period of the last game as opposed to reacting to the Leafs.
Thank you, Darcy.
Thank you, Scott.
Bob.
Thank you, Scott. Leafs on the power play, all right, and Sundin couldn't handle that pass. It bounced high, and Cote kept it in on the blue line for Sundin. Again, he's covered. The Leafs on the power play, 0 for 3. Only four shots on their three power plays. Sabres shoot it down the ice. Just ripped it. 40 seconds gone in the penalty to Ward. Kasha doesn't stop it. Leaves it there. Sabres play. Down the ice again. 4 minutes left of the period. 5-0 Buffalo. Big, comfortable lead. The Sabres have established in the second period. The goal in the first, shorthanded by Ward, who's now in the box. And four goals here. Leafs in attack. Took lots of time to kill more time. 40 seconds left in that penalty to Ward. Perreault brings it up. Left it at the blue line. Perreault again takes the pass. Cuts it back a bit. Open man was near the line. That's Sullivan. Flipped it ahead. And again from the blue line. Long drive, rebound. To the side of the net, no harm. The Leafs are on it though. Classic against the post on the near side as Barron is all the way back and Sullivan that lost it against Juno. And the penalty has 5 seconds left. So, Sabres have killed that off. Ward now on the ice. And on the puck, Dixon Ward steps over the line, rips it off to the left of the Joseph. And the Leafs. Leafs are spinning, no doubt about that, with the attack Sabres in this period. Goals in 2 minutes and 35 seconds. Two scores in just 22 seconds. They've added a fifth. Sanderson, number two in the period. 14-10. 2 minutes and 10 seconds left in the second period, which has been a disaster for Toronto. Sabres will take a 3-1 lead in the series unless the roof caves in. Game 5 is back at the ACC in Toronto on Monday, 7:30 Eastern. All uphill now for Toronto with a minute and 45 left in this, the second period.
Remember your first car? It changed your life. You were automatically cool and the envy of every single one of your friends. How'd you like to feel like that again? Motor Trend's Car of the Year. The new 300M from Chrysler.
Thomas coming in the center ice area, just outside the Buffalo line. The Leafs have had 16 shots now on Dominik Hasek. He's been very careful, he's been very steady. He has been Dominik Hasek. No goals. There's another point. Roll left behind the goal line. Roll up to the net. Brown comes back to help. His own zone. Couldn't find it. And away comes the Sabres. Pass behind Sanderson. Dean Chetan trying to bring it in. It's Toronto. Poked at it. And again, he lifts it over the line, but right on the ground stick. Skates away from Bear. Played it up the center. Down across the line is Chetan. A trick. took the two to Sanderson. Up to the line, Brown.
That's the play in this period.
Final minute of this period. No shot. And it's shot off a stick. Sanderson looking for the third of the period.
27-17, Buffalo. The shots, the chances. And Dominic Hasek has not been tested like he often is, but he looks sharp. And if he looks sharp to me, he must look sharp to the Leafs shooters. A half a dozen stops, you might say, that were of the difficult variety. No problem at all, at least the one that we can see, with the fact that his movement is impaired at all by that groin. And here's a good illustration as he goes side to side, touching both posts with both feet. And a guy with a bad groin, he'd be screaming under those circumstances.
They saw him just inside the Leaf line, won by the Toronto Maple Leafs, and Kotek leaves it for Coverlay to shoot it down the ice. He did that all right. That was another icing call. Well, the other big series is on tomorrow afternoon again at 2 o'clock Eastern in Dallas, Colorado. And the Dallas Stars, that series, and Andy tied. Chris and JD will have all the action for you. We're talking to Canada, CBC, brings you Game 5, Colorado Dallas.
It's a great series, and anybody can win that one. It's a 2-3 now with Dallas and the home ice at men.
Buffalo has outchanced Toronto in this period. This is his 15th straight time. Scored four goals. Well, that'll tell you something about Joseph. He's made some dandies.
There's nothing wrong with Joseph's performance. He's an orphan out there today.
18 seconds left in this second period. Sabres keep beating the Leafs. The penalty is called on that one as the Leaf players hurt on the far side. I'm not sure the penalty was called.
I don't think a penalty is called, but he went piling into the boards as he tried to make the takeout. Hard to see who it is. Chris Broadhurst, the trainer, and Dr. Clearfield, the doctor, are already out there.
He's Lonnie Bahanas, is it not?
Yes, it is. He went to take the Sabre player out right in front of the Sabre bench and kind of went off the back of him and spilled into the boards in an awkward fashion. And not often do you see the trainer and the doctor out that quickly. So it's Steve Thomas, not Lonnie Bohannes. Thomas playing under less than...
Yeah, it is.
Less than 100% physically. Looks like he's all right, but he was looking for the takeout. Let's have a look at it here now. He missed Warner and then kind of tripped over the back of him and went into the boards in an awkward fashion right there. Lucky he got turned, so he didn't go in head first. But we do know that he's playing less than 100% with an injury, as many players are, and those kinds of spills are not what you need when you're already unhealthy.
Buffalo leads Toronto 5-0. And only 10 seconds left in the period. 27-17. The Sabres are out shooting the Maple Leafs over two periods of hockey in this Eastern Conference. Flat.
Every statistic you look at, Bob, turnovers, body checks, blocked shots, chances to score, shots on goal, they all tell you the same story. On the scoreboard, 5-0 Buffalo.
Sabres putting on a good show to take a 3-1 series lead in this Eastern Conference Final. This period is done. Got something going near the blue line, though. Dolby. And there's a Bray tied up. I think so. Nothing developed. Period is over. And the Sabres are in command of this one.
Guy Domi challenges Rob Ray, but there's no percentage in Ray getting involved in anything with Ty Domi. They've fought 100 times, I think, in their career.
So this invitation is turned down by Ray, but they won't all be turned down by him. All right. The Buffalo Sabres are ahead of this one. 5-0.
Oh, what a shot. Grandparents dream, what a shot you just got. So cute you could scream from as close as a kiss or across the room. Every shot's a sure shot with a can of sure shots. Oh, what a shot. Hear the cheers of the crowd. What a shot you just got. Don't you feel proud?
Wow, you took that shot?
Every shot's a sure shot with a can of sure shots.
Sabres leading 5-0 after two periods. Here's the Leafs' Gary Volk. Gary, how would you describe the challenge facing this team in the third period?
Well, I mean, what we have to do is have a good third period so we can carry that home, get a little momentum. You know, I mean, if we just have to do something positive out there in the third period, whether it's score a couple goals or get some hits or something that we can carry over into back home with us. And then you never know. You win a game back home, and then it's a series again.
You guys have yet to lose consecutive games in the playoffs. Clearly, that record is in jeopardy tonight. How did the wheels fall off so badly?
Well, you got to give them credit. They really crashed our net hard. They threw a lot of speed at us, and we tried to we just seemed to get behind the eight ball early, and our mistakes compounded into others. And we got to regroup going into the third period here. We didn't get this far by giving up. We're not going to give up. We're going to try to do something positive this period we can carry on home with us.
Appreciate you stopping to talk to us, Gary, under difficult circumstances. Thank you.
All right.
There's Gary Volk of the Toronto Maple Leafs, who are down by 5 after 2. Stand by for the Satellite Hot Stove. That's next. The Stanley Cup playoffs continue on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Hey, how did this happen? It's not really you, is it? I mean, you were always so more out there. Now this is more like it. Honda has just what you need. Take a demo ride. These bikes will astound you. Great deals, easy turns. Now is the time to buy. So stop sniveling and get out there.
What are you looking for? A color bubble jet printer that neatly packages the fastest printing in its class? Separate ink tanks that can be replaced when each color runs out? And breakthrough technology that produces the sharpest images never seen before on this planet? Then you'd better get your hands on this one. The BJC 6000 from Canon.
We are just outside of Winnipeg. Marcus is on the phone talking to his boss, breaking the news to him.
It's me, Marcus. Mr. Peters, listen, I'm going to need a couple more weeks. Thank you.
So, how'd it go?
Oh, it's a Stanley Cup. He understands.
A whole lot can happen out of the blue. The bat blue.
He fired you, didn't he?
Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Thank you.
Satellite Hot Stove, brought to you by Bell Canada.
Fellas are in Dallas, and I'm sure you're happy to hear, John and Al, that Darren Pang, star of the Memorial Cup champion Ottawa 67s and ESPN, has joined us here at the rink in Buffalo. And Darren, let's get right to it. Goaltenders Dominik Hasek took a little heat in the Buffalo media, and the chap that did it on radio is not here to defend himself, but you, like everybody else, seem wild that it would even be suggested that he was either pulling the chute or not showing enough character to play with Payne.
You know, I don't listen to the show, but I thought I'd tune it in the day of the game, and I was infuriated with the comments, and I was infuriated with the fact that fans were calling in, and not only does this guy not give anybody a chance to say anything, but there wasn't a whole lot of people backing up Dominik Hasek, and It's not like he's a guy that's got a, you know, bad shoulder or something you can tape up. It's a groin. This guy stretches just like JD used to stretch. I mean, that's a lot of stretching that goes on right there. And if you can't stretch and you have some hesitancy and you can't play, you can't play. I thought he was courageous to step up and say, I can't play. You know, it's not like he has anything to prove playing-wise. And so I was a little disappointed by it all, and disappointed that he didn't receive a little bit more support locally.
Yeah, it's a strange opinion, but it's talk radio, and sometimes you get on one side of it, and away it goes. John, did you want to add to that?
I think Hajduk's a world-class athlete. He's a world-class competitor. We've seen that in the way he's played for the Sabres. We saw it in the Olympics, and if anybody doubts his heart, they're wrong.
There's only one guy that knows the answer to that, and it's Hajduk.
Yeah, and he knows when he's got to be healthy enough to, when he is healthy enough to come back and play, and he was right. He came back, and he was healthy enough to win a game.
Well, since you're angry, John, how about the situation in Ottawa?
Oh, that's interesting what's going on there with the Rick Dudley scenario. I think my feeling is, you know, you see smoke, you know there's going to be fire around there somewhere. So I think that the new ownership of Tampa Bay definitely has something going. They're trying to find a way to get Rick Dudley down there, probably going to clean house down there. And I feel bad if Jacques Demers gets moved out. And I what I don't understand here is Rick got an opportunity to go into Ottawa, work for that franchise as a general manager in the NHL for the first time in his career, and all of a sudden something pops up and somebody wants to leave. If I were the Ottawa Senators, I'd hold the Tampa Bay organization up to the bitter end and get as much as they can compensation-wise if Rick were to leave to go down there. Ottawa's done nothing wrong here.
No,
they've done everything right. Yeah,
but
the Gauthier thing was very upfront with ownership there, from what I understand. So that and he did have an out. Here, Rick Dudley has a contract with Ottawa, and in this situation, Ottawa ought to stick to their guns and do what's right for the Ottawa Senators.
Does that open the door for the former Chicago Blackhawk winger Steve Ludzik?
Yep, yes,
and the whole Detroit Viper thing going in there?
Yeah, that's exactly right, Darren.
That's the only 3-0, right?
That would be the only slack I cut Dudley, John, is that he does have an allegiance to Davidson. Bill Davidson
Okay, Ronnie, but does that mean you start with a network and all of a sudden they give you a job somewhere, which is a great job, and then something else pops up and you're going
to
jump over there?
Hockey Night to Fox, something like that?
Well, no, that's not quite right, because I'm getting the job done, I hope. I think that there's honor involved here, though, isn't there, Ronnie?
No, I do, too. And you know who's twisting in the wind is Jacques Demers, and who's twisting in the wind is Dudley himself in Ottawa.
The talk of John Muckler going up there to replace Rick Dudley's wrong. He's in a good financial situation with the Rangers. He's staying with the Rangers.
Well,
that's just not going to happen.
It started, though, because he's such a good friend of Roy Malacher's.
Yeah, but it's not going to happen.
They've been friends for, I think, 30 years.
A person like Scotty Bowman coming back to coach is great financially. For him. It's great for John Muckler financially in New York doing the job there. I don't think Ottawa is going to bring in a guy like John Muckler and pay the freight that it would be.
Well, at least they know they'd trust him. He would stay.
All right, Trevor Linden to Montreal. Darren, what's your reaction?
Well, I think it's something that Montreal Canadiens could use, a little bit of character down there, but I think there's a lot for Trevor Linden right now on a career point anyway. He's got to battle back here. I mean, there was a very disappointing time in New York. It's an opportunity now in a pressure situation in Montreal, and he's got to raise his level of play as well. This is going to be very interesting for the Montreal Canadiens and to see where they go from here.
Yeah, but to be perfectly honest, I like Trevor. He's one of my very favorite people, and he's a character guy. But the numbers that they're paying him, which is $3 million, $3.5 million, $4.5 million, $15 million over 4 years, is simply too much for Trevor Linden. And the Canadiens got beat, I think, on both fronts, because they also gave up a first-round draft pick, and that was number 10, and that's an awful lot to give up in what is a very good draft year for a guy who, while he is a quality player, is still a second-line player and is not going to be the answer to your problems. He's not going to replace Mark Recchi.
Now, does this mean that Linden replaces Mark Recchi? Now, with Dom Fuss maybe signing in San Jose or wherever, do they get a first-rounder back for that?
They will if Dom Fuss signs with San Jose. So but that won't be as high as the one that they lost.
That's a high pick they lost.
John and Al, the one thing I'd say about what you're saying, Al, is you look at Guy Carboneau or Pat Verbeek or some of these players who you would say to yourself, there's no way I would pay Guy Carboneau $3.5 million, and yet in the Stanley Cup playoffs you put him against Forsberg.
Well, yeah, but he's a fitter. He's a fitter for this money here in Dallas.
Part of a good team.
Yeah, this
Montreal doesn't matter.
Not a good
yeah, but
team.
He
oh,
helps.
It does
oh, it does matter. He helps guarantee a lot of playoff games here the way Carboneau can
yes,
play
he
against
does.
Peter
That's
Forsberg.
Right. And I'm saying Linden could do the same for you. You get into the Stanley Cup.
But
I know
Montreal's not Vancouver. But Montreal's not in that position, Ronnie.
As soon as
they
get Modano and Nieuwendyk, then he'll be a big help.
Yeah,
I'd like to see him in an environment where there's a little bit more pressure. There's no pressure playing for the New York Islanders. And things were going really bad in Vancouver. He's a character guy like you guys said, and maybe this will just raise it up a notch. Maybe we'll be surprised by what he brings to the table.
New York Islanders guys are going to be the Montreal Expos of the NHL. This is a team that's dumping all salaries. They're going to have a $10 million salary structure. It's going to be, I think, embarrassing unless they make some changes.
Yeah, Linden's just the beginning. Palfy's going as well.
We heard that somewhere.
Yes, we did. And we also heard Hasek was going, but that they deny emphatically here. Fact is, they're making money hand over fist with the playoff performances. Thanks to Darren Pang and to Al and John Davidson.
So Belt Visual Call Waiting lets you decide if you want to take the call, even if you're on the phone. With me to demonstrate, it's my mom. And she's getting another call. Look, Mom, it's your friend, Cynthia. What do you think?
Well,
Cynthia's not really a close friend.
Yeah.
More of an acquaintance, really. We barely even know her. She doesn't come by anymore at all. I don't know what happened.
Satellite Hot Stove. Brought to you by Bell Canada.
Buffalo playoff tickets. Who's got tickets? I need some tickets here, folks. I need five. But I'll take one.
Oh, this man, cold love.
Once every decade, something hits the shore that redefines excitement. This decade, it's the all-new Suzuki Vitara convertible with drive select 4x4, a new 2-liter twin cam engine, and legendary Suzuki dependability at a price that guarantees the most fun you can have with your top down. The new Suzuki Vitara convertible. All you have to do is drive one. Right now, get a Vitara convertible 4x4 from just $17,795.
CBC.
Yeah, I mean, you could probably disconnect from everything else.
Wonderful.
Any questions? Watch them.
Command here at Marine Midland. Last night at McNichols in Denver, Brett Hull, with less than 4 minutes to play, scores a huge goal to send it to overtime. The Dallas Stars looking to go up 3-1 in the series heading home, but in overtime, Ozilinch with the pick and the feed to Chris Drury. He scores the winner with 30.8 seconds to go in the OT. So Colorado ties the series 2-2 with Game 5 tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific. A team has never rallied from a 3-1 series deficit in round three or beyond. And it doesn't look good for Toronto, down 5-0 through 2. Third period action coming up from Buffalo, New York. And we continue on Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup playoffs.
I'm of two minds about my Cavalier. One side of me said get it because of its 35 standard features. But the other side said, hey, look, it's pretty hot.
It's dependable.
That's why more Canadians have bought Cavaliers over the last 10 years than any other car. I feel great driving this car. And you know what? No matter how you slice it, this is a great deal at $178 a month.
You gotta love people. All winter long, everyone says it's too cold. And then summer comes, we get a nice stretch of heat, and everyone says it's too hot. People, let's make up our minds. Well, thank goodness for Tim Hortons Iced Cappuccino, the new perfect summer treat that'll beat the heat. It's creamy, smooth, it's deep down cool, and it's just $1.69. Hey, this iced cap cools you down when it's hot, which is good, because you wouldn't want to be hot when it's hot.
Please release me, let me go. Release me, my darling, let me go.
June 3rd is the date of the Ontario election. If you haven't received your notice of registration card, bring the proper identification with you on election day and you can still register to vote. It's not too late to protect your right to vote. For further information, look for our ad in your daily newspaper or call us at 1-888-ONT-VOTE. That's 1-888-668-8683. Elections Ontario, keeping you informed.
Some things can't be explained, only experienced. Casino Niagara, this is the one.
Times like this, it's good to have a sense of humor. Glenn Healy's the right man for the job as he goes in for the third period here in Buffalo. It's 5-0. The Sabres in command. Here's Don Lever now with Scott Oak.
Don, you got Groshek, Hasek, and Chatan back for game number 3, and clearly you expected better things, but surely nothing like this. How do you explain the explosion?
Well, they got a little flustered. We got two real quick ones, and our guys just have some great wheels tonight. I've never seen a skate like this in a long time, so it's very timely.
It was all working for you in the second period. Rob Ray scored even, no disrespect to Rob intended, but they all seem to be going in, and Harry has made the point that it's not Curtis Joseph's fault that he's been left alone. Do you agree with that?
Oh, completely. Razor's was a deflection he knocked out of the air, and Sanderson, he had no chance, or Holzinger, he's in all alone, and they got a little flustered there, and we just kept coming at them.
Thanks, Don.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Scott and Donnie. Don's wife, Karen, was one of the guests fortunate enough to be at Peggy Neal's house last night for a spectacular
235,
barbecue.
235, was it?
Yes, it was, Bob.
Jeff.
235 when we went home. Bob, your mic's hot, and it's up to you for the third period action here at the Marina with Harry Neal. Harry, thanks for the great dinner last night.
Face-off coming up now for period number 3. And Glenn Healy has come in to play goal for Toronto.
I think it's a good move by Pat Flynn. Nothing against Joseph. He's the only reason that their teams are still out there. But Healy gets a chance to play Joseph. I'm kind of surprised, Bob, that the rough didn't take Hasek out.
Might do it yet.
See how the period
on Coles. But Buffalo in command. No question about that. They continue to come. Pekka just missed getting a clear shot to the net. Toronto bring it up. Johannes tried to go in, and he stopped. Jimmick found the goal, poked it away, and Murata just in time flipped it back for Jimmick to get it out. Smelik played that one out, and then was hammered back in. Back to pick it up. Two teams changing as we play. 1 minute now of the third. What a great position Buffalo is in now. Leading 5-0. Coming into the third period. A chance to go 3-1 in the series. That's a stranglehold. Sure. Next game is in Toronto on Monday at 7:30 Eastern. Up skating room to come out of the net. Gets it up the center ice. The Leafs can't penetrate. Again, it's dropped back, and Karpachev fired one in. Right on the net. Cleared by the goalie. Knocked down ball. Johnson. Shot stopped by Hasek. Boy, he took a while getting back up on his feet that time. Hasek was down and made the save, and then
Solomon's
trying to scramble back.
Sullivan's going to get a goaltender interference penalty, Bob, as he knocked Hasek down, striding through the crease. And we're going to have a look at it right here. Sullivan will now go to the, try to go in behind Hasek and knocks him down. And goaltender interference is the most popular call at Marine Midland tonight. And that is the third time we've seen it. This is a tough spot for Coach. If you're in Pat Quinn's boots, what do you say to your team? I think the only hope is, let's see if we can win the third period, get a little respectability back, see if we can get feeling a little bit good about ourselves, and stop this slide of death. It's a tough sell, boy, to get your players to believe that that's any kind of a good idea.
The Leafs have been having a tough time with the middle period of these hockey games. These playoffs, rather, did they have one tonight? Bears a shot. That's gloved easily by Hasek. Leafs intercept again, right in front is Bolt. And he's covered in time by Zhitnik. Sabres trying to get it going on a power play. The only thing they haven't got tonight is a power play goal.
The record is 16 straight playoff games. The Edmonton Oilers did it. Tied with the Islanders in Philadelphia at 13.
Roshek shooting it in. Healy out of the net, was steered away, but it's not out. Maple Leafs get it out now, down the ice. Woolley will come back to take it from the goalie. Penalty time, 1:08. Woolley had to back up. In there and chases him again. And the pass is lifted over center ice and the Sabres get it in. Healy in goal for Toronto. 5-0 Buffalo. Power play Buffalo. Outside with the passing. Schmelik. Head with him. Chetan shot. Blocked. They pick it up again though. Juno and Chetan. Back and forth. And again, Chetan. Pressure by this Buffalo power player. Good. On the outside, continue to control it. Pass to Schuller. No shot from him. Bad angle now. Now he's better. Pass left, and Healy made a good move to get over across the crease. Penalty is over now. Now, with the puck. Gets it back, and there's Sullivan. Out of the box, he picked it up and raced away. But there were two Sabres back. One of them, Patrick, took care of it. 4 minutes gone in the third period. Shot down the ice. It's a call against Buffalo. Still 5-0.
Currently we're somewhere out west looking for a shinny rink.
Gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
Yeah. First goal gets the cup.
That's gonna hurt.
Don't you just love playoff hockey?
Oh, what can happen? Out of the blue. The bad blue. Hey,
oh, this man, cold love.
Gone in the third period, still 5-0 Sabres. The Leafs have declared that Steve Thomas will not return tonight. Injury information guarded very carefully in the playoffs. It is known, though, that Thomas has been playing with a shoulder problem in his past few games. We could speculate that he aggravated the shoulder injury when he fell into the boards late in the second, but that's only speculation. Nonetheless, he will not return tonight. And the big question now is, will he be available in Game 5 when the Leafs will need him a whole lot worse than they need him in this period, Bob?
Well, Scotty really went into the boards heavily. No question about it. He aggravated something. And let's hope that a little aggravation. Steve Thomas has been a spark plug with this Toronto Maple Leaf team the whole season. Through to the playoffs. Shut up. And Healy in stick to intercept the pass from Pekka. And ice again. Sabres can put her in cruise control now. Following pass of Ward cruising in. Sundin gets to the line. Throws it through. And Hushing the ball right now. Get the right pad on that. And Buffalo will get it out and down the ice. Yes, it coming. With 14 minutes and 54 seconds left.
Climate like this, we know your engine takes a beating. That's why Motomaster offers an entire line of climate-proven Formula One oils. Like Formula One Synthetic, it flows evenly year-round. So from a cold start to 450 degrees running, your engine has true protection at any temperature, under any condition, in every one of our unpredictable climates. This is the climate. This is the oil. Motomaster works here.
Game 5 coming up in Toronto on Monday. At the ACC, 7:30 Eastern Time, the start. Miskevich missed the net with a shot from the blue line. Sabres clear. Ray, who has a goal, his first goal in the playoffs, in this hockey game tonight. Miskevich coming back. Toronto skate out. Rowe getting the center. And to the line where he loses it.
Sabres with the return of Chatan automatically gave them a very dangerous offensive forward line that they went without for 9 games. He's one of those players that makes his teammates, his line mates look better. We've seen that already on 2 assists, and here's another example of his ability to find this line mate in the clear. And the guy that looks like he's enjoying it the most is Jeff Sanderson playing with Chatan.
Come up after the Leafs again. Forechecking hard. Johannes. Rink wide pass. Nobody down there. McKee was there. Put it up to Karpinsev. Got it down the ice. No icing. Waved that off quickly. What a Rasmussen. Who picks it up and tried to skate away himself. Big take care of Johannes. He centered it. He hit the pads of Hasek. Is being called against Hasek and the Buffalo Sabres.
And the Leafs will get the choice of anyone on the ice to take it. Matt Sundin is out there. He's already missed one of these playoffs.
Now this takes us right back, Harry, to Nagano, Japan. Dominic Hasek in a shootout. And we're going to find out who. Nobody's come from the Leaf quintet yet. The referees are talking at center ice to the Buffalo Sabre, Holzinger. And he learns what it's all about. And it's called now.
They're going to try and get Sergei Berezinov to take it, but he wasn't on the ice when the play was called. But let's have a look at the play here.
And on the puck. There it is.
Right there. Wasn't on for very long, and Matt Sundin is the nominee. He's checking the puck to see if there's any chips in it. He doesn't want it rolling.
Well, Dominic is right on the goal line now in his crease. Left hand up on the crossbar. Right hand, the stick off the ice. And he's staring down at Matt Sundin, who's now picking it up. And let's watch. Hushik out. Penalty shot in Maple Leaf playoff history.
I don't know if any player, we'd have to check the record book, has any player ever had two penalty shots in one playoff? Dean has. One for two.
500 feet back. But not good tonight. It's a 5-1 hockey game. The goal by Sundin on a penalty shot coming at 6:59. Now Berard is trying to get in on that. Rolling out of the net. Berard. Berard behind the net. There's Berard.
From Suzuki.
Bad weather ahead. Shift into four-wheel drive.
The Grand Vitara is the only SUV in its price range with V6 power. Because in the game of life, winning is everything.
Suzuki, all you have to do is drive one.
Get a 99 Grand Vitara V6 from $23,495.
I've heard people say that too much of anything is not good for you, baby. It's just not enough for you. It's just not enough.
Oh, oh, baby.
Oh, baby.
My darling, I can't get enough of your love, baby.
Saves in the game now. This is a good one.
Yes, Kevin Adams walks in after he strips McKee of the puck, tries to go across in front, and Hasek sticks his stick out in a poke check fashion and lost it. Adams kicks the stick, as you can see, so it wasn't a throwing stick. And Magic Sundin with that penalty shot is the only player in the history of the NHL playoffs to get two in 1 year.
There's Domi intercepting a pass. Back in front with a shot. By Barazin was off a stick and over the net. But Domi keeps it in. Hasek stepping out of the net. And he got the puck out of the zone. Coverly. Backing up in his own territory. On the pass across center. And Petrick had that. Anchors double in there. Coverly again. Shot the center to Petrick. Thought he was hit after the whistle.
Well, let's have a look at those two penalty shots that Matt Sundin's had. The first one against Van Beesbrouck on the left of your screen. He tries the same play, this time on Hasek, high to the glove side. This time he finds the top of the net instead of the top of the glove.
Good shot by Matt Sundin. Just under the crossbar. Start to go down, and that was enough for him, and right away. You think they decide before they take the puck in center ice or wait for something to happen?
Not when Sundin gets his stick out to the side. The puck's in front of him. You can see the puck and the goalie. I don't think he thinks before he does.
Brought it back in with Sullivan inside.
Well, the penalty shot is the only miscue that Dominik Hasek has made tonight. He looks in complete control. He doesn't look like there's any problem with his groin and is giving the Buffalo Sabres a good night in the nets, as he so often has. He's had many busier ones than this one. And Wayne Rollison on the end of the bench there is back in his backup role. Playing a lot better since sitting on the bench. There's nothing like a taste of the pine to catch your attention, and Grosick was sitting as a healthy scratch at least four games. And I think with the return of Chatan, Grosick and Chatan can sing some nice songs together, and you can see the Leafs 9-1 shots advantage as Buffalo's trying to kill the third period off.
Buffalo won game 3-4-2 with an empty netter. Of a leaf net. 5-1, Buffalo.
How fast are the new Hondas going right now? Real fast, during Honda's Checkered Flag event. There's Canada's number one selling car, the Civic, with a lease of just $208 a month on the Coupe DX. Or lease the spacious new Accord LX sedan for just $318 a month. Honda's Checkered Flag event. Move fast. Save big.
Lots of long-distance companies let you save money when you call at night. But have you seen what they're charging you during the day?
At Sprint Canada, there's no difference between night or day. You get the same low rate no matter when you call.
For $4.95 a month, call anytime, night and day to anywhere in Canada and pay just 10 cents a minute. Call 1-800-THE-MOST today.
Night, day, it's all the same to us.
When it comes to news, rely on The National. The National, Canada's newscast, weeknights.
Face off to the right of... Big backup goalie, Matt Healy. Came on in here in the third period to give Curtis Joseph a break. Harrison will bring him offside.
Well, if you're a Leaf fan, May 29th is not one of your favorite days on the hockey calendar. May 29th, 1993, Wayne Gretzky, in the seventh game, puts the Leafs out of any hope of return of going to the Stanley Cup Finals. The LA Kings beat the Leafs, and Wayne Gretzky, as he so often has, but this is a little bit different than most of his goals. It goes off the skate of Dave Ellis and goes in.
You know, but talking to Wayne, thinking about all the series of games he played, as the Leafs come in, and this cleared off Perreault's stick easily. He calls that little flip you saw there, that game, that series, was his favorite of all time. That's something.
Stanley Cups he has. Anyway, May 29th is nearly over. The Leafs have got to start the focus on May 31st. Healy's done a nice job jumping in under adverse conditions. The Buffalo Sabres are not forechecking like they did in periods 1 and 2. They're just making sure nobody gets trapped. And Curtis Joseph, on a rare occasion, watches the third period of a game he started. But it isn't because he didn't play well. They're trying to get him in the best possible shape for game number 5.
He had 27 shots in his two periods.
Referees over at the timer's bench talking to him about something. I don't know what the problem is. It appears to be corrected as they're ready for the faceoff.
Healy has had just one shot so far in his third period. Intercepted with a few passes in his crease area. It might have ended up being a shot, but did not because of his quick moves. Now on Barnes to get a goal now. You hear him holler stew when he is on the ice. More especially when he takes the puck, and now he's got it. Listen to him. Trying to get his goal, Healy on the short side. Good Barnes, behind the net, dumped it out front, and the Leafs pick it up and get it ahead. Sullivan had to stop to pick it up. And they rolled the pass ahead now. Grosick nearly got going. And out the helmet is Chris King, and he lifts one into the Buffalo zone. 6:55 left. Buffalo will go on 3-1 in the series just by hanging on now in this one. Domi went in to grab his man. Did grab his man. The play continues. How the Sabres get it out down the ice. Markov behind the net. Now you see it. Sundin didn't know the pass was coming. Lifted a little short one in there, and Ward tried to get inside. Murata couldn't get back, Ward for the ball. And again, Healy covered on the post on the short side. Ward and Murata nearly get another one for Buffalo. Healy stopped him.
Of all
all the reasons to choose a Chrysler minivan, there are a whole bunch we had nothing to do with. Rediscover Canada in a Chrysler minivan. Call 1-888-456-5555 for your free Canada vacation guide.
Grata nearly scores the sixth goal as he cuts in from an impossible angle, and the puck got in behind Healy, but he sat on it.
Ote and Kovalev, the defenseman, together. Ote started the play, and that's broken up at the Buffalo line. He's shooting down the ice. Nice thing coming up with 5:53 left.
Well, the shots are 9-3 for the Leafs in the third period. Score 5-1 Buffalo. And Glenn Healy, who's playing the third period, makes an awkward but effective save right here. And it was awful close to being in the net in the air. But Healy, who's sitting on the goal crease, catches the puck. Keeps it out.
He has been a great guy as a backup man for the Maple Leafs. You know that Curtis Joseph, most of the time, will start the games, and most of the time will start in the games. He's won some for the Leafs this year, but he couldn't do it tonight. This Buffalo team, full marks. He came out hitting, skating, passing well, shooting, everything. Only thing they did get tonight, so far anyway, is a power play goal. They've done that at least once in every playoff game this season. Now the puck is knocked down to the blue line. 5:25 left to play. Ferrari get a shot from there. This pass is easily intercepted. Stop on the center ice. Buffalo bring it in. Centering pass, and Huskisson just missed it. And Huskisson with a big hit. Juho Kotkaniemi. Healy had to be careful with that one. Good pressure by this line for Buffalo. Holtinger, Juno, and Rasmussen. Ferrari will have to contend with Rasmussen now. Good get it out. Holtinger! Rasmussen behind the goal with it. Slicking through his skates and out. They hit the back of the net. He's on it again. Around the goal. Out front, in the slot. And finally fell. Trying to move up on it. Harrell's long pass out of the reach of Harrison. 4:32 left in the third period.
Excuse me, we're having a class right here.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this won't take a minute. Just keep breathing.
We need to talk. What do you think you're doing?
I'm you, and you're me.
Why did you cancel our appointment with London Life?
London Life?
All of our retirement dreams are just gone.
I didn't do anything. James, tell her.
Me.
The glider. The freedom, the independence.
We have a glider.
Yeah. Just make the call.
You look so cute with hair.
Talk to your London Life representative today.
Give me the phone.
About a Freedom 55 plan for your future.
This is a popular night for the Buffalo Sabres fans. Fortunately, they're not typical ones.
Nice.
I'd be dancing too. My team was up 5-1, one game away from the Stanley Cup final. That doesn't make you dance in this business, nothing.
Some of the crowd are figuring they've had enough, they've seen enough. The game should be won by Buffalo, and they're getting a head start on the traffic leaving this Marine Midland Arena in upstate New York, Buffalo.
Well, there was a significant number of Leafs fans here, but they've become as silent as the Leafs goal scorers have.
Matt Sundin, the only goal scorer for Toronto in this game with only 4:26 left. And he got that one on a penalty shot back at 6:59. That made it 5-1.
Stop into Canadian Tire for everything you need to get your car back on track. Canadian Tire, still the right place to do it.
Lindy Rupp and his assistants, Mike Ramsey and Don Lever, have done an exceptional job with this Buffalo team in the last 2 years.
Score big. Canadian Tire. Still the right place to do it.
Curtis Brown gets the penalty, and with 3:33 to go, the Toronto Maple Leafs will get a power play.
Brown, 2 minutes for obstruction tripping.
And he tripped the lead players. Bohannes, as he was trying to get behind the net to recover a loose puck. Let's have a look at the penalty here. The trip right there. Bohannes would have won the race to the puck, but was tripped.
This is the fifth power play of the hockey game for Toronto. How many shots have they had? Six. From the blue line, Berard. Chopped into the corner, all right. Sullivan missed it. It's high over the boards near the Buffalo bench. As a matter of fact, into the player's bench. Face-off will come to the left of Dominic Cachet.
Well, the Toronto Maple Leafs will leave right after the game, go back to Toronto, and they'll work out tomorrow in Toronto, and Buffalo will practice here. And they'll take the bus to Toronto around 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, getting ready for Monday's fifth game of this series. And the Leafs will be down 3-1.
And that game is at 7:30, Monday evening, Eastern Time. Hockey Night in Canada on CBC, the full network. Game 5. Puck into the crowd again. 3:18 left. Big second period by Buffalo in this one. And that was curtains for Toronto. They scored 4 times. Two goals in 22 seconds.
Sanderson has really come to life in these playoffs, and especially late in the playoffs. Time 40 goal scorers. Goals production has dipped badly the last 3 years, but he's beginning to get the bomb sights honed up again.
It was that span of 2:35 when they got the 3 goals that did the Leafs in. They poured everything properly in. Joseph, beautiful passes, breakouts, odd man rushes, and just simply great shoots in on the goal.
Sundin in front of the net. Another shot, score! Sundin I think, 32 seconds. It was the second attempt that Matt Sundin found the puck, kicked it up to his stick, and snapped it in. And I don't think Ty Domi's going to get an assist, but he got Big Schmelik right in the way of Dominik Hasek, and he never did see that shot.
I wonder if that first shot didn't hit Domi, did it?
I don't know whether it got through or not, but it came right back. Let's have a look here. Here's the first shot. It looked like it hit Schmelik, and the rebound came right back, and then he snapped it up over Hasek.
Well, Sundin got the goal. We know that. 5-2, 18-03, the time of the goal.
Second round of the goal, his second of the game, and eighth of the playoffs for number 13, Matt Sundin. Assistant number 28, Ty Domi, and number 42, Kevin Adams. Sundin
did get an
from
assist.
Domi and Adams. A power play goal at 18-03.
Also got an assist. 18-03. Power play goal for Sundin.
In Canada, brought to you by Labatt Blue. A whole lot can happen out of the blue.
Currently, we're somewhere out west looking for a shinny rink.
Gentlemen, the Stanley Cup!
Yeah. First goal gets the cup.
That's gonna hurt.
Don't you just love playoff hockey?
Out of the blue. Labatt Blue.
Hey,
road. Validating tires.
What kind of road can you drive on with BF Goodrich tires?
Approved. Enjoy.
Any road you choose. BF Goodrich tires. Take control.
So Belt Visual Call Waiting lets you decide if you want to take the call, even if you're on the phone. With me to demonstrate, it's my mom. And she's getting another call. Look, Mom, it's your friend, Cynthia. What do you think? Cynthia's not really a close friend.
Yeah.
More of an acquaintance, really. We barely even know her. She doesn't come by anymore at all. I don't know what happened.
How fast are the new Hondas going right now? Real fast, during Honda's Checkered Flag event. Now the Accord LX sedan, listed among Car and Driver's 10 best, is leasing for just $318 a month. Or lease the sure-footed four-wheel drive CRV for only $338 a month. Honda's Checkered Flag event. Move fast, save big.
Buffalo Sabres grab control of the series. They didn't score a power play goal. Perhaps the Leafs can celebrate that back. Tough night for Toronto, there's no question. The Ford 3 stars here, Rhett Warner, Jeff Sanderson, and the Calder Cup winning goal was scored 3 years ago by Brian Holzinger, who had a big one tonight, Scotto.
That he did, Ron. Brian, if anyone had told you before this game began that you could handle the Leafs this way, would you believe them?
Absolutely not. We've been pretty fortunate to be able to score some goals against them, and I think the biggest thing we wanted to accomplish, especially with two games here at home, is to play well defensively, and I think we accomplished that.
Everything was working for the first 40 minutes. Were you surprised after two periods to be sitting on a 5-0 lead?
Oh, absolutely. I think the first period we came out with exactly what we wanted. We came at them strong, and in the second period we were able just to put four away, which doesn't happen too often against these guys. But again, it was a good, solid defensive effort, and I think in the third period we let down a little bit, but... We got to build upon the first two periods for Game 5.
The politically correct answer is to say that you expect them to come out strong in the next game in Toronto, but they're on the brink, and I'm wondering if the Sabres have that killer instinct. Do you smell blood here?
Well, we certainly do. I mean, we've been pretty successful in putting teams away, but we got to have that goal in mind right from the get-go. We know it's not going to be easy in their building. They came out in the third period and really took it at us, but they have a lot of pride over there. We know that, and we just have to go out there and play a boring road game, and we'll take our chances.
24 years since this team has been in a Stanley Cup final. Have you guys talked about that?
Well, not really. The biggest difference from last year and this year was that we weren't as happy to get to this point as we were last year. We've been in this position before, and now we want to take it to that next level, and now we have a great opportunity to do that.
Brian, thank you for your time. We'll see what happens in Game 5.
Okay, thanks, Scott.
Ron, back to you.
Brian Holzinger, and you know what? Buffalo's 6-0 on home ice, perfect. And that third period, you may say if you're a Toronto fan, that's great, we can build on that. But Buffalo and Lindy Ruff's probably saying, that's good. They got a couple of goals. Maybe they feel like it wasn't a blowout hockey game. Look at that one two ways. In any event, 3-1 is the series lead for the Sabres. Game 5 Monday night. The French Connection, of course, got them to the Stanley Cup in 75. Ricky Martin was hot then. They are definitely living La Vida Loca right now. The Stanley Cup crazy life in Buffalo.
The kids come first. They're always on your mind. They're always first and foremost there.
I work at Ford Motor Company. I'm an engineer, and I'm also a mom.
We know what it's like to have kids, and that helped us design this car.
Safety was the utmost importance, and the 5-star rating was a big deal.
This sensor is really smart. The beeps get faster as you're about to back into something.
I designed it for my neighbors. I designed it for what's now become a part of my life.
My mom built that car.
The Ford Windstar, designed by moms, built right here in Canada.
Meet Diane Bogan. Diane always dreamed of owning a lakeside cottage. So Diane came to us, and we helped. Now she has a place where she and her family can escape to each weekend. A place where she can relax. A place where she can, well, she's doing it right now, isn't she? Happy landings, Diane. Introducing a new way of borrowing. The Scotia Total Equity Plan. Get what you want out of life.
Lots of long-distance companies let you save money when you call at night. But have you seen what they're charging you during the day?
At Sprint Canada, there's no difference between night or day. You get the same low rate no matter when you call.
For $4.95 a month, call anytime, night and day to anywhere in Canada and pay just 10 cents a minute. Call 1-800-THE-MOST today.
Night, day, it's all the same to us.
From the business in the boardrooms to the plays behind the plays.
He gets $800,000 for scoring 20 goals, and you should get the same.
A fascinating six-part series on a year in the life of the NHL. The New Ice Age, Monday, June 7th on CBC.
5-2, the Buffalo Sabres beat Toronto, and Associate General Manager Michael Smith joins us. That's a tough night. And Mike, my question to you was, do you think that maybe those two goals will camouflage the fact that you were blown out early and that you'd Buffalo would be happy the fact that Toronto got a good third period out of the way?
No, there's no disguising or camouflaging the, you know, we got trounced tonight, and two goals are, looks better in the newspaper tomorrow, but it won't change the feeling inside the locker room.
What happened?
I think we got a little rattled on that second goal and we lost our composure. It's only maybe the second or third time all year that's happened, and all of a sudden the game was over.
Yeah, that's bang on. There's no question that was a turning point in this game. How about the only other thing you could maybe look at is Hasek saw a lot of shots tonight. That's one thing. Maybe physicality. Of those two areas, what would concern you? The fact that Hasek's seeing it too easily? Nobody's in front?
He looked pretty sharp tonight. I think that's... he looked much sharper tonight than he did the other night. He was moving much better, challenging the pocket. There wasn't much to shoot at. Not that in the first two periods we had a lot of shots, but... I thought he was very strong.
How'd you feel about Curtis?
It was a tough night for Curtis. He didn't really have a chance in most of those goals. They were in giveaways, and that happens.
Do you think you have to hit more?
We don't have a team that is an overly physical team. Our game has been speed generated by moving a puck in a flow, and particularly game three and a little bit in the first period tonight was much space, and I don't think we're going to change our style. We're going to have to be a little more intent and do what we do best, but I don't think we're going to come out and try to out-muscle Buffalo.
You have been resilient all year long. That point's been well made. This, as you say, when that second goal, it was such a shocking turn of events that everybody, and it happened two games in a row now where you've had these quick three unanswered goals. Where do you find the resolve this time out, do you think, for Monday?
Our team's been very responsible all year, and they'll be responsible again. Tonight was a disappointment, but for our team this year, we've had other times and been disappointed, but it was short-lived. Our team's been very, very responsive to our coaching staff, and I'm sure they'll be much better in the next game.
Our thanks to Mike Smith for coming in. 5-2 the final score. The Buffalo Sabres grab a 3-1 series lead. Dominic Hasek, as Mike says, looking sharp in his second game back. We'll continue on Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup playoffs.
So Bell Visual Call Waiting lets you decide if you want to take the call, even if you're on the phone. With me to demonstrate, it's my mom. And she's getting another call. Look, Mom, it's your friend, Cynthia. What do you think?
I
remember. Cynthia's not really a close friend.
Yeah.
More of an acquaintance, really. We barely even know her. She doesn't come by anymore at all. I don't know what happened.
Chic FX Performer, the only razor with revolutionary flexible blades that bend to hug the contours of your face. For a closeness you'll want to share.
Chic FX Performer for a close, smooth shave. Chic, the feel of smart design.
Hey, hey, you!
You!
Well, get into my car!
Get into your Mazda dealer spring breakthrough sales event. For breakthrough deals on every new Mazda. Get 1.9% APR financing on every new Mazda 626, even the 626 LX V6, priced less than the Camry LE 4-cylinder. Hurry into the Mazda Spring Breakthrough event today.
Might have hurt even more to know that Rob Ray got the game-winning goal. He came in for Primo, who was injured, and Ray scores here. That made it at that point 3-0. Incidentally, still no further word on Steve Thomas, who left the game in the second period. Colorado-Dallas, we're back on the air in just over 15 hours.